On Game Show Network, anyone can win terrific prizes like this. Broyhill's Home Office Armoire conserves space and fulfills home office needs. Wrap-around doors, pull-outs for keyboard from Broyhill.
Put the channel setting on your television. Okay. Memorize the number. This is your lucky number for the rest of the day. Keep it tuned to Game Show Network and good things will follow.
Welcome to another Game Show Time Warp. Today, we're going back to September 1982. With two premieres we're going to focus on. To honor the Price is Right's 50th anniversary. Unfortunately, the September 1982 episodes of The Price is Right have been blocked, so we won't be able to show them. Today, we're going to be doing time warps on both on my YouTube channel and my Internet Archive. On today's episode, we got you a classic September 1982 episode, 82 episodes of your favorite game. Coming up next.
What's it take to make us smile all over that refreshing taste of Coca-Cola? Have a Coke and a smile.
Doing a lot of things that they're not famous for. Julius Erving's playing as good a defense as anybody in basketball right now.
Well, the Celtics outscored Philadelphia 10-1 to get to within six, and we'll be back with the second period after this word from your local station.
Saturday, Walt Disney presents Ron Howard in the heartwarming story of Smoke, a stray dog that brings a new love and a new challenge to a boy who must learn to become a man.
This is CBS.
We've made an improvement to famous Glidden Spread House Paint, but it's not on the label because the improvement's in the price. Now Spread House Paint is on sale for only $11.99 a gallon. And the same great improvement applies to Glidden Spread Oil Stain. It's on sale for just $10.99 a gallon. But you better hurry. Glidden Spread Oil Stain and Spread House Paint will always be great, but the prices may never be better.
Available at Maven Paints and Richard Harding Paint Shop.
The ultra mileage Nissan Sentra, number one gas mileage car. Look at that highway number. Look at it.
You need it.
Nobody has it but your Datsun dealer.
You need this mileage. It's number one. You need this car. It's number one.
You need it.
New Nissan Sentra.
Fame, the ultimate American dream, Monday.
20 Olympic medal winners play in the NBA. Davis, Jones, Ford, and me, Tom McMillan, to name just a few. Now the NBA has adopted Special Olympics. We're playing, learning, and we're having fun. We're reaching out to the mentally retarded. So together, you might call us the League of Olympians. You too can join. Please volunteer.
The preceding message has been furnished as a public service by the National Basketball Association.
Ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from The Young and the Restless, Melody Thomas, McLean Stevenson, and Marcia Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Thank you. What did the market do this morning?
Look.
Oh, Bob. Bob Donner, what's wrong?
One more winner, Gene, and I'm done.
You don't want any more winners on the show?
Woman hit me like a typhoon.
Do you see what you did to him,
That's
Rochelle?
Funny.
I'm proud of it.
You're proud of it?
Rochelle's proud of it?
Yeah.
I ought to punch her out.
Yeah.
You married Rochelle?
But not seriously.
God, I hope he knows.
Is he here?
No.
No.
I said it wouldn't be a pretty sight.
Oh, it wouldn't be a pretty sight. Well, I think the least you can do for injuring this man is go up there and give it a little kiss and make it better.
Oh.
Right? She's not going to hurt me, is she, Gene?
No, she won't hurt. Now, gently now. Promise you'll be kind. No. Get back. Ha! Ha! Does this excite you?
Getting well, Gene.
Yeah. Made it
getting well.
Good. All right. You all remember these two kooks from yesterday, don't you? Gabrielle Williams is married and has one child. How old's your child?
He's 4 years old.
His name is DJ. What is that?
Damien Jason.
That's a very pretty name.
You just hear my husband's name.
What's that?
Rudolph Valentino Williams. Junior.
Rudolph Valentino Williams?
Yeah.
Hey, Rudolph Valentino. I remember her well. Now, Rochelle, you remember, the mad woman of Shio. Where are you from again?
The Valley, Van Nuys.
Oh, I figured it as much. And you have how many children?
I just have one, and she'll be 7 tomorrow. Can I say happy birthday?
Sure.
Happy birthday, Aaron.
All right. Good luck to both ladies. We start the second game, first round. Gabrielle, you go first.
I'll take A.
A it is. Here we go. Sarah said, this restaurant serves such large portions, instead of a doggy bag, I need a blank bag. Carl's doing a little artwork, so we'll go ahead. Sarah said, this restaurant serves such large portions, instead of a doggy bag, I need a blank bag.
A trash bag.
Trash bag. All right. Not bad, is it?
No, trash bag is a very good answer. Unfortunately, I said elephant bag.
Elephant bag. Doggy, elephant, bigger animal. I got the drift there. Well,
I believe... Now, this is a match, my darling Ira. I know this is a match because a hefty bag is a trash bag.
All right.
What every red-blooded, tough, and wild cowboy would say, Gene, a horse.
A horse bag. The old feed bag. That's a large bag, isn't it? This restaurant serves such large portions. Instead of a doggy bag, I need what kind of a bag, Melody?
Garbage.
A garbage bag. That's another one, too, for Gabrielle. What do you say?
Well, since Brett said a hefty bag was a garbage bag,
right.
I said what Brett said, I said a hefty bag.
A hefty bag. Good for her.
Gene, I don't know what a gal has to do to be noticed around here. I've been sitting here for 10 minutes with my entire front flashing.
An almost perfect person, it says on her entire front.
That's, as you know, I am now a hyphenate, a producer, Off the Wallace Productions.
Off the Walls, yes. Production?
This is the name of my play that I'm in at the Pen Andreas with the Summers woman directing.
Uh-huh.
So even as we speak now, we're in it.
Really?
Yes.
You're rehearsing now?
No, we're doing the play.
We're doing the play.
Yes.
Can I come and see it in the next 3 or 4 days?
From this show? Absolutely.
Well, see, when will this show won't be shown for a while? We actually open on November 7th.
That's right.
We play this...
for an indefinite run. It'll probably run for
that
a year.
That was November 7th.
Probably
this
be
past.
Like Oklahoma Fiddler on the Roof. I know that we'll still be running when this is on.
Right.
And running and running, and we hope it won't be out of town.
Well, I will come and see you.
Oh, please do.
All right. Now, may we
oh,
see
you probably
your
won't
answer?
Answer.
Yeah.
Oh, an
large
answer.
Large portions instead of a doggy bag. I need a trash bag.
Duffel bag.
A duffel bag.
Good
a good response. 3 for Gabrielle. Now let's see how Rochelle does with hers. All right. Gary said my uncle Louis has all of Manhattan tattooed on his body. It's wild. He's got the Empire State Building tattooed on his blank.
Let's say
here it is. I wonder if put Bob, Brett, and Charles downstairs, and Melody, McClain, and Marsha upstairs. If they would finish sooner than...
I strongly doubt that.
Oh. Here we go. Gary said, my Uncle Louie has all of Manhattan tattooed on his body. It's wild. He's got the Empire State Building tattooed on his blank.
Tushy.
On his tushy. Empire State Building? Oh, we were thinking of...
That woman. She was won $5,000.
Tushy right. Is round and, you know, it's...
I want to tell you, you better not boo that woman, because that woman will come out there and clean house on any damn one of you.
Right. Single-handedly.
That's right. You can send up your strongest. I'll bet on her. I assume the man was... I'm sorry, was I...
No, I'm sorry.
He likes you. He just likes your material.
I assume that the man was standing on his hands, and therefore it was on his nose.
Aha! Right. Good. Response. Don't boo that answer. It's a good response. Nose is good.
I thought there was only one answer to this. One and only one.
Right.
But we couldn't say it, so what did
you
say?
No.
Nose. Right. Two noses so far.
Now, I hope this doesn't offend the judges, or you think it might be in bad taste.
Let me peek it. Arm. Oh, no, that's all right.
Oh, that's pretty tacky.
Well, no. I had you wondering there for a minute, right?
Yeah. No, any long appendage would be fine in this case.
Well, of course, I beg your pardon.
He's got the Empire State Building tattooed on his...
Well?
Fish. One. That's a long appendage. I've never seen one.
Yes. I'm sorry.
She wore the sloppy sweater and the blue jeans just for your benefit.
It's not sloppy. Don't you see my giraffe? My giraffe is doing.
What? Look at that giraffe.
Yeah.
Look at that crazy giraffe. Wait a minute. Zoom in on that giraffe.
My God,
look at the monitor. Why, that lucky stiff.
Yeah, he's just looking for... See, there's more. He's looking for...
Oh, he's looking for the other, his friends.
Well, the... back here.
Aha.
Not having any fun at all.
Sorry, well, okay, yeah. I guess that's all the mileage we're going to get out of her giraffe.
I understand. I couldn't think of anything, so I just said his chest.
His chest?
Yes.
Yep, you drew a
blank. Fire cry from his bummy.
Yep, that's right. What do you say?
I say, how you doing, hon?
I'm doing very well,
good,
thank you.
Good, I'm glad to hear you. You look fabulous.
Thank you, my dear.
You're more than welcome. Nose.
Nose, all right. So it's 3-1 at this moment in the end of round one. Gabrielle's ahead. We'll go to round two in a moment or so. Now this for you. Here we go. Round two, final round, final game for these two ladies. And Gabrielle, you're ahead, so you have to go first.
I'll take A again.
All right, three people play. Bob, Charles, and Marcia. Ken said, this weather is really terrible.
How terrible is it? Oh, that's awful.
That's very half-hearted on your behalf. It's so cold, I saw a polar bear at a department store trying on blank.
Cute. Adorable.
All right. I guess we're all ready, Gabrielle. Ken said, this weather is really terrible. It's so cold, I saw a polar bear at a department store trying on blank.
A fur coat.
A fur coat. You have a pained look on your face, Bob Donner. Bob Donner?
The operative word, Gene.
What?
Is cold.
Cold,
if
right.
If you're cold, you put on a sweater. The guy already had a coat.
Right.
I'm not arguing with you. If you want fur coat, you got fur coat.
Oh. All right. Bob Donner, what do you say, Chuck?
Well, I don't know about what this is, but maybe it's a match. A parka.
A parka. They're usually, they're down-filled or filled with a...
Parka's a funny word, though. You know, anything with a K in it is funny. Duck is very funny.
Duck is
one of the funniest. Guam is funny, too.
Guam
is funny, and six is the funniest number.
That's
and Cleveland.
Right.
And Cleveland is always a million laughs.
Right.
Cookie and car keys is funny, too.
Well, you got a little catching up to do here, Rochelle. You need 4 to tie and 5 to win. This is it. Ed said, nobody likes me.
Oh, poor Ed.
Even my blank forgot my birthday. You're the only one of those. Well, you can sell an answer to him and make a little money on the side.
Let me see, Uncle Gene.
There you go, sir.
Nobody likes me. You think about your own life, dear.
him the hat.
That's beautiful. That's genuine.
Who gave you the hat, honey?
Oh, don't lie.
All right. Here we go, Rochelle. Ed said, nobody likes me. Even my blank forgot my birthday.
My mother.
My mother.
All right.
Let's see how many mothers we got up here.
Oh, well, don't
right,
be rude.
Bob.
I got one mother who's going to get ready.
All right.
Mother.
All right. Thanks. Keep your seat, Michelle.
To all you mothers out there, mom.
Mommy dear.
I said to the guy, why you mother?
This show conceivably could be playing somewhere, sometime, in some market, the week of Mother's Day. Yeah. And that's... you're being so irreverent. What do you say there,
McLean? I'm
McLean?
Off the hook. I'm off.
I know
I gotta tell you,
hook.
This could be a big day for me. If crazy shell...
Because it's 5-4 right now. It's 5-4 at this moment. One more mother wins the game for her. If you don't come up with a mother, it's a tie.
If I do come up with a mother, do I get attacked?
Yes. She comes over. All
right. Stand in the blue mark.
Don't move off the blue mark. It's bad luck if you move off the blue mark, okay? And to touch my body is also bad luck. Don't touch me. Gabrielle. We got some prizes for you. What have we? Oh, we got a case of indigestion, a parking ticket, all kinds of wonderful things. It was a pleasure to meet
you. I really had a fun time.
Gabrielle Williams, some prizes really look to coming your way. Hi. You ready?
Yeah.
There it is. We polled an audience, nice, smart bunch like these, and said, write down your best answer to this. Golly blank.
Oh.
Golly blank.
Brett.
Golly gee.
Marcia.
Golly, Miss Molly.
Golly, Miss Molly.
Yeah, it was a Little Richard song.
Oh.
Oh, all right.
And Robert, Bob.
Golly, Moses.
Golly, Moses?
Yes, it came to me.
Holy Moses.
From the mount?
From the mount.
Uh-huh. On stone, was it written?
As it was ripped, yes.
As it was ripped. Golly Moses.
Ever. On a tablet.
Yeah.
In the reed.
Golly Moses. How come you don't get a hernia carrying that stone around? All right. So we've got Golly Moses, Golly G, and Golly Molly. Do you want one of those? Or maybe you got a better idea
no.
in your own head. No, no, no. All right, I won't argue with you. It's all right. I don't want to argue with you. Go ahead.
Go, oh, baby.
Tell me. What?
Golly G.
Let's
Golly
go.
G. Okay. Golly G. That's you've got Golly G under the $100 response.
Golly
Molly.
There you laugh, you scoff.
Yes, right, we scoff.
You laugh, you scoff.
We apologize for scoffing.
You should.
May we see the next one, please? Golly Moses.
Oh, ye of little faith.
Right, I was one of little faith.
All right, sweetheart, anything.
Well, Golly G, looks like a...
Better be there.
Me.
Kiss the suit. Goodbye, Gene.
Golly G. All right. Right.
Bonner.
Now, listen, you got $500. It means the least to play for is $5,000. But before we ask you to spin the wheel, we want you to see this message, if you please. All right. Rochelle has won the $500. And as we pointed out, the least she'll play for is $5,000. Let's see what happens with her second spin of the star wheel.
No
Good
clue.
Luck. Let's root for a double. Another $5,000. Ready,
oh,
Melody.
Yes.
This is your first time doing this part of it, but there's nothing to it. It's a piece of cake. Ready? Here we go. Blank, buff, B-U-F-F. Blank, buff. I'll just let Melody take a look at it. Make sure we all understand the word.
Thank you.
Your job is to match Melody. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say to that?
In the buff.
In the buff? What does that mean?
That's nude. Being
naked.
Nude.
Oh, naked.
Really? Oh, yeah.
But I'm having fun.
Why don't you ask Melody to demonstrate?
You're having fun? So are we. All right. Melody, she says in the buff will match you for the $5,000. But she's not too sure about the answer. What do you say?
Well, I thought immediately my first name was Art Buff.
Yeah,
I
Art
thought,
Buff.
Well, so I changed it.
Listen, we're very happy for you, my dear. You have a total of what? 11,000? How much has she got, Marcia? $11,000. We're very happy for you. Congratulations, Rochelle. All right. Now, let's welcome two more players. Here comes Marcy Bennett and Rip Riddle.
She's gone?
She's gone, yes. It's all right now.
How did we ever get her on?
Just lucky, I guess.
I'll be up here.
All right. What do you want? No, listen, we've welcomed Marcy Bennett here and Rip Riddle. Let's find out where they're from and all that. Marcy, tell us about you, please.
I live in Huntington Beach.
Huntington Beach.
Huntington Beach. I'm a cocktail waitress.
Yeah.
And I'm ready to play.
You are?
Yeah.
Follow me. Rip Riddle. Who named... What? Excuse me. I was just leaning on it. Where are you from, Rip?
I'm from Fountain Valley. I'm a recreation superintendent with the city of Costa Mesa. I have a lovely wife and a little boy and a little girl. And recently, I have quite an interest in the game of golf.
What's your handicap?
Right now, I play to about an 18.
It's not bad. What's Rip short for?
When I was a youngster, everybody called me Ripple instead of Riddle.
Ribble is your... Yeah, I see. So, Rip Riddle. All right. You want to do a commercial here? All right, we'll do a commercial. Can you stand it another minute or so? All right, stand by for this commercial. Thank you. I thought we'd have time to do one question for each of you, but or at least one for Marcy, but we don't have time. We'll look forward to seeing you next time here in the match game. Thank you, Marcy and Rip. All right, look forward to seeing this pretty lady on The Young and Restless on CBS. What are you up to?
Mork and Mindy.
Mork and Mindy.
Gork and Windy?
Is it true, everything I've been reading about that
show?
Yes, it is. All right.
And Jonathan Winters is going to be the son, right?
That's right.
Yes.
And I'm directing Miss Marcia Wallace in a play, which is going to be at the Pan Andreas, starting in November and probably going straight on through until the spring.
Break all records.
Break all records. It's on Santa Monica Boulevard in your West Hollywood area.
Longer run than the Fantastic.
I wouldn't be surprised.
I wouldn't be
Good
surprised.
Good luck with the roof, all of them.
Sure.
God knows I came here an ingenue and I've turned into a character later.
You know if we're going to have our bath now or after we eat. Because the new nurse is so mean to us, Uncle James. I think she
Gene
might
Rayburn
be
here. Join us next time for the match game. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive... A Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner with pure wheat germ oil and honey for fresh-smelling hair with Super Shine Super Body. And Flavor Ice, America's favorite quick-freeze fruit-flavored bars. 24 giant bars in the package, assorted delicious flavors, Flavor Ice, the giant cooler. Easy Caulker, foam caulker, and easy insulator for wider gas. No gun, no mess with either can, easy caulker, easy insulator. Raid Crack and Crevice Spray, unique extension wand spray is hard to reach places to kill crawling bugs.
Picasso. Mondrian, Van Gogh, Montalban.
Tooth angel.
Dollar than tooth fairy.
That's it. You got it.
Draw your own conclusions. Win, lose, or draw weekdays at 11:30 a.m. Eastern only on Game Show Network. Yeah.
Melody.
Okay, kids, take a break.
Coke is it?
Coke is it?
The most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Coke is it?
The biggest taste you've ever found.
Coke is it?
The one that never lets you down.
Coke is it? The most refreshing taste.
He won a couple of games, won $1,050, but got beaten by the devil twice, and he's anxious to rectify that situation. So, Charlie, would you introduce the champion and the next challenge?
Our current champion, whose winnings in cash total $1,050, he's a foreman for a manufacturing firm, and he enjoys cooking, bridge, and traveling, Ken Nash. And his opponent, he's the manager of a fast food restaurant, and he loves to read and sing, Chris Gibson.
Ken and Chris, welcome to the Joker's Wild. In the last program, Ken, you won a couple of games, won $1,050. But despite the fact that your aunt's out there in the audience rooting you on, the devil beat you twice. You weren't too upset, I hope.
No, I cried a lot.
Well, I understand that while you're crying, you also cook up fancy dishes.
Oh, yeah, I cook up a lot of, like, pupusas or chicharron.
A what?
Pupusas con chicharron.
What is that?
Well, it's made out of cornmeal and little patties that you mix up. It's a lot of work to go through it.
Do you enjoy your own cooking?
Oh, yes. Well, every now and then I do make a mistake.
Everyone.
Well, I made one big one. Because I like fried chicken. I also like curry chicken. So one day I decided to combine the two, and I made fried curry chicken. I buried it in the backyard.
So instead of being buried, you're curried, your chicken was buried. I see. Chris, tell us about yourself. You like to sing. Where do you sing?
Oh, I sing at my home. I put on shows for myself.
For yourself?
Yes. I stand in front of the mirror and I put on a show, then I give myself a standing ovation.
I gather you like your performance.
Very much so.
Just out of curiosity, when you were doing that, did anybody ever walk in and see you doing it?
Oh, my little girl is there all the time, and she claps because Daddy sings better than anybody.
Are you a good singer?
I think so.
Shall we test them?
No. No.
No. Here is your chance, Chris.
No.
National television, millions of people watching, producers, directors, and you would rather stand in front of your mirror and do it?
Yes, I would.
I can't intrude on his privacy. Gentlemen, here are the categories in the game. Fast forward trivia, action books, famous lovers, Middle East, and the world of music. If you take fast forward trivia, you can answer as many questions as you like. Chris Gibson, you're up first. Good luck.
Joker.
Action books, The Joker, and fast forward trivia.
Jack, I'll take fast forward trivia for $100, please.
No, it's, yes, you're right, for $100. If you answer five correct questions, if you give me the correct answers, you could win the game. But in any event, 10 does get a final turn. Question one. One common psychiatric term refers to an abnormal fear of enclosed or confined spaces. Name that familiar phobia.
Claustrophobia.
That's right. You have $100. Want to stop or go?
Go.
You want to go. One phobia concerns a person who will stand in front of a mirror and sing.
That would be chrysophobia.
I am chrysophobia. Very good. I'm joshing you. The Russians formed their official state news agency in 1925, and it is responsible directly to Russia's highest executive body. Name Russia's national news service.
TASS.
Yes, that's correct. You know, all of you obviously watching the Joker's Wild for years know that I have this card and the questions on it and also the answer. And for the sake of accuracy, our researchers put down other acceptable answers. I mean, TASS is only one answer. For your information, the other acceptable answer that the researchers said I could accept, in case the contestant gave it, was, please accept Telegrafno Agentstvo Sovestnatskiyo Sozoya. How come you didn't know that one, Chris? You gave me the hard one, TASS. At any rate, you now have $200. You want to stop or go?
I'd like to go, Jack.
All right, you're risking it all. You know, if you miss, you back down to zero. As an athlete, he was the only gold medal winner on the 1932 United States men's swimming team. As an actor, his roles included Tarzan and Flash Gordon. He is Buster who?
Crab.
That's correct. You have $300. The decision gets tougher now because if you miss now, you lose $300. You want to stop with $300 or
Let's
keep
go.
Going? Keep going, okay. For $400 or for nothing?
Okay.
Superman kept an eye on things in Metropolis while working at a large metropolitan daily newspaper as Clark Kent. His journalistic job was with the daily what?
Planet.
Yes, that's right. You have $400. You have $400 if you stop now. Next question is $500 or nothing.
Go.
Going all the way, huh? Correct answer would give you $500, enough to win, but you don't have to stop. You can keep on going. If you miss it, you're back down to zero. Here is the question. The lyrics of a 1964 hit by Jan and Dean proclaimed the fame of a little old lady from a certain California city. For $500, possible victory, name the California city.
Pasadena.
You're right, you have $500. I know I'm going to ask a dumb question, but do you want to continue or do you want to stop?
I'll stop.
If you had gone on, I'd have to send you to the nearest psychiatrist. You have $500, and Ken, you also can get the fast forward category. If a joker comes up, you can substitute, or you might get it naturally, or three jokers, anything short of that. And we have a new champion named Chris Gibson. You've missed it. Joker, the world of music, and a triple.
Yes.
Yes, what?
Oh, all $200.
I beg your pardon?
Well, that's it.
Well, it isn't. You could have, yes, that's why I waited, but I can't guide you to it. You could have gone off the board with the joker and taken the trivia
right.
category. As a matter of fact, I had said it a moment ago,
right.
If you got a joke, but you elected not to do that, or it is not easy up here on television. You get befuddled easily. And so, ladies and gentlemen, with this kind of a down note, we have a new champion. His name is Chris Gibson. However, Ken, you don't go home empty-handed. You won two games, of course, and you take home with you all cash of $1,050. A nice hand for Ken, and we'll play against that devil, and Chris Gibson will do it in just a moment. Chris Gibson, you're sure the winner. Come on over here and play against the devil. That's good.
Thank you.
You feeling good, huh?
Yes, indeed.
Yes, indeed.
Your daughter out in the audience, by any chance?
Yes, my daughter's right there.
Where is your daughter? Which one?
Right there.
That's your daughter. She's the one that stands there while you're in front of the mirror and doing your thing, huh?
No, I have a baby girl. She couldn't be here today.
Oh, I see.
Courtney.
I see. All right. Well, you're going to play against the devil now, and all you got to do is avoid the devil. If you can get to $1,000 without seeing that devil, I'll give you the $1,000 and
you.
These gifts.
Chris, divert your attention to these great gifts designed for different creative diversions. First, Chris, this gift will satisfy your want to create pictorially. It's a terrific new movie camera. For this, you'll receive an Alden's catalog gift certificate. Enjoy convenient at-home shopping from over 40,000 items, famous brand names, all at Alden's low prices from Alden's catalog. Then, if you've ever fancied yourself a novelist, try your creativity on paper with this fabulous portable typewriter. Olympia's Report electric typewriter combines the versatility of a portable typewriter with the speed and comfort of an electric model furnished by Olympia USA. And finally, Chris, when you're in the mood for music, create your own melodies on this gift worth over $1,800, this sensational piano. The Winter Spinet, incomparable beauty with unusually brilliant tone. Soft, low silhouette and hand-rub finish, everybody's favorite. A quality product of the Aeolian Corporation, this creative diversions package is worth in cash and prizes over $3,650.
Give him a spin, Chris. Good luck. First man, he gets. I must say that's three times in a row I think the devil has come up.
At any rate.
Yeah,
fourth time might be the charm. Right?
Might be. Go on back and play another game. Nice hand for Chris. Charlie, who will he be playing against next?
Well, Jack, she's a costume designer who likes opera, baseball, and making dolls. Ellie Rosenfeld.
Hello, Ellie.
Hi.
What kind of dolls do you make?
Well, they're cloth dolls. They're about 30 inches big, and I embroider the faces. They have yarn hair, and I usually base them on characters from operas that I haven't been able to design yet.
Very nice. Do you keep them yourself?
No. As a matter of fact, the first that I made, I gave to a friend's mother who is an opera singer, and she collects dolls. I thought it was a great gift for her.
You're a doll.
Thanks.
Take a look at the categories here in the game. They are the art world, followed by nursery rhymes. Then we have biblical things, old TV, and finally Midwest State. You're the challenger, Ellie Rosenfeld. Spinning, good luck.
Thanks. Joker, come on.
Old TV, Joker, and a cricket.
I'd like old TV for $200.
The plots on the TV series The Honeymooners often dealt with the get-rich-quick schemes of Ralph Cramden and his friend Ed Norton. What's the last name of the actor who played Norton?
Carney.
Art Carney, one of the great actors of all time. You have $200. Good start. Chris, your spin. Old TV, Midwest States, and a pair.
Jack, I'll take Midwest States for $100.
The nickname of this state is the Sunflower State. Its people are called Jayhawkers, and more wheat is grown there than any other state. Name this Midwestern Plains state.
Kansas?
Yes, that's right. You have $100. Score is 200 to 100. We'll find out who wins the game in just a moment.
Contestants will receive.
Presenting the multivitamin and mineral health food that's low in sodium, high in fiber, and tastes great. Chiquita Bananas. Take one per day.
Also, Honey Nut Cheerios. Tempt your tummy with a taste of nuts and honey. It's a honey of an old. It's Honey Nut Cheerios. Okay, Jack.
Score is 200 to 100, and Ellie Rosenfeld is your spin again.
Okay, come on, Joker.
Joker, Joker, nursery rhyme.
Jack, I'd like nursery rhymes for 200, please.
By sticking his thumb in a pie to pull out a plum, this nursery rhyme character proved himself to be one of the sloppiest eaters in fiction. His name was Little Jack what?
Horner.
Yeah, right. You have $400. Chris?
Joker.
Nursery rhyme, Midwest State, biblical saying.
50, Jack.
An oft-quoted saying from the Bible warns, neither cast ye your pearls before what?
Swine.
Yeah, right. You have $250. Kelly.
Come on, Joker.
Joker, biblical things, and a triple.
Jack, I'm going to go off the board for nursery rhymes for 50.
Okay. According to the nursery rhyme, Hey Diddle Diddle, one of the characters laughed at the cow who jumped over the moon. What kind of animal was this amused onlooker?
The little dog.
Yeah, that's right. You have $450. Yes, then, Chris.
Joker.
Joker, nursery rhymes, and the art world.
I'll take nursery rhymes for 100, Jack.
According to one popular nursery rhyme, a famous tub became home to three men. One was a butcher, one was a candlestick maker. According to the rhyme, what was the occupation of the third?
The baker.
Yeah, correct. You have $250. Okay, Ellie.
Hey,
Joker, Joker, Midwest State.
I'd like Midwest State for 200, please.
Correct answer would make bring you $650 and win you the game. Caution the audience, please. One Midwestern state has a nice sense of balance. It leads the nation in the production of milk and cheese, and more beer is brewed there than any other state. For $650 and the championship, name the state.
Wisconsin.
You win the game. I'm sorry, you don't win the game. I don't often make that mistake, but I've forgotten that Chris is entitled to one final turn. But you have $650, which means, Chris, that the only way you can beat her is to get three jokers. If anything comes up other than three jokers, Ellie is the new champion. Good luck. Give him a spin. Nope, it's all over. Now you win the game, Ellie Rosenfeld. Congratulations, Ellie. I didn't mean to scare you that way. You won $650, and in a moment you had a chance to spin against the devil. Well, Chris, you only had one game, which is too bad, because I think that you would have beaten the devil the next time up, but you do leave with $500. A nice hand for Chris. And Ellie, come on over and face the devil. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, you know how this game is played.
Yes.
You're going to spin against the devil. And all you have to do is get to $1,000 or more without seeing the devil, and you'll get a catalog gift certificate, an electric typewriter, and a piano, plus the $1,000, of course. All told, you'd have prizes of $3,650. You ready to go?
Sure am.
Give them a spin. First thing gets you, $200. Oh, boy, I want to tell you, the devil is on a rampage.
He really is.
Now, I'm going to give you a little breathing time. I'll see you on the next program, because I want to go out in the studio audience and give the people out there a chance to win some money. So we'll see you next program,
okay.
And good luck.
Great.
Okay?
Thanks.
Him for three people in the studio audience to play against that old devil, and he's been ornery. Who are the lucky three?
Jack, we're looking for Wayne Smith. Barbara Bernstein. And Merle Griffith. Here's your chance to face the devil.
Well, where are you from?
Mission Hills, California.
Mission Hills, California. Nice to have you with us. What do you do out there?
I'm a retired deputy sheriff of Los Angeles County.
A retired what?
Deputy sheriff.
Deputy sheriff. Well, I don't go fool with you. I don't want any trouble. The object here now is to try to spin here and get the highest amount you can. Whatever you spin is yours. It turns out that you're the highest of the three. You then get a chance to play against the devil. Give him a spin, Merle. Merle spins it again. 40, 80. That's pretty good. $110. That's a good one. Hi, Barbara.
Hi, how are you?
Where are you from?
Woodland Hills, California.
I see you have the Barb knitted on you.
Right.
I have a daughter, Barb.
Oh, it's a terrific name, isn't it?
I think so.
Good.
What do you do in Woodland Hills?
I'm a market research interviewer. I talk to all kinds of people on all types of subjects.
About what?
Today I interviewed people on cat food.
Cat food.
Oil.
Did you talk to any cats?
No, but I got two kittens.
Two kittens you talked to?
I brought home two kittens.
Aren't you lucky? Give them a spin and see if you're lucky in doing that. Beat $110. 10, 20, 120. Yeah, you did it. You're right on top at the moment. Hello, Wayne.
Hello,
where are you from?
Well, I'm originally from Oklahoma, but I'm in California temporarily.
Temporarily?
Temporarily.
Deciding whether you like it or not?
No, I like it. I love it.
Waiting whether they throw you out or not.
Yes. No. Depends where my company sends me.
I see. All right, Wayne, well, you've got to beat Chia. Merle got 110. Barbara got 120. I know you'd like that trend to continue.
I certainly would. All
right. Wayne spins it again. 10, 60, and 110. Now, you win, Barbara. You two guys tied for second, but that's not good enough. You have $110, and wherever your company sends you, I hope you are very happy. Wayne? And Merle? No, there's no tie. The winner is $120. And Merle, you have $110. Here you have $110. Good luck to you. And we're back to you, Barb. You are the winner. You have $120. And now you're going to get a chance to play against the devil. And if you can get to be $1,000 or more, I'll give you not only $120, but another $1,000 and this gift.
It's a beautiful room full of family furniture. Sofas from Howard, one of America's leading manufacturers. They use premium oak and the finest fabrics. Relax on calming curves of oak with Howard, a leader in family room furniture. This game is worth exactly $3,000.
Come off.
Give him a spin and you'll see. 50, 100. 50. That's 200. 50, 25, 75. 25, 50, 25. That's 450. 50, 100, 100. That's $700. 150, 25, and 50. That's
9, 25, 75, 100.
$1,300.
What's that?
Furniture? What'd you say? You don't
believe it?
I'll tell you why you don't believe it. 100, 200, 300. 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000, 1,100, 1,200, 1,300, and the $120 you won. Here's 100 and 120 all told with the furniture. You're winning right out of our studio audience in cash and prizes.
I don't know.
$3,420.
Get in touch with Game Show Network. Log on to our website and play our games or email us your questions and comments. It's www.sony.com/GameShowNet. Game Show Network. All play, all day.
Well, we have no time to say anything except goodbye. We'll see you on the next program. Bye-bye, everybody.
Some of our departing contestants will receive Artmatic Cosmetics, exciting in-fashion colors for lips, eyes, nails, and cheeks, all rich in moisturizers. The proof is in the wearing. Also, don't vacuum. From now on, electric broom, with the most advanced electric broom of all. The two-motor electric broom power team makes cleaning a breeze.
Coke is it?
The most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Coke is it?
The biggest taste you've ever found.
Coke is it? The one that never lets you down. Coke is it? The most refreshing taste around. Coke is it? Coke is it?
From Television City in Hollywood, this is the $25,000 Pyramid. Today's special guest from Knot's Landing, Constance McCashin, and from Private Benjamin, Robert Nandan. Your host is Dick Clark.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Gee, that feels nice. Feels like old home week. Thank you and welcome once again to the $25,000 Pyramid. Every day of the week, we give two contestants a chance to win $25,000 in less than 60 seconds, and it could very well happen today. Constance, when you were a contestant on this show, did you ever win any money?
I won
About $2,000. And
bad.
I won a year's supply of turtle wax.
And you went on to greater things. It's nice to have you back.
That was pretty nice.
Do you know your partner, Scott Richards?
We just met.
Hi, Scott, what do you do, sir?
Yes, I'm a seminary student and a part-time youth minister in Agoura, California.
Nice to have you here, sir.
It's good to
Robert Mandan, you have, over the years, been responsible for giving away a lot of our money. Are you ready to do it again?
I surely am.
Say hello to Janet. Is it Gleason?
That's right.
As in Jackie?
That's right.
No relation?
No.
What do you do, Janet?
I'm a waitress at in Corona Del Mar.
We're very happy to have all of you here. Wish you all a lot of good luck. Let me explain how you can win $25,000 in less than a minute. We play two games every day. Now, if you win the first game, you go to the big pyramid board over there and you try for $10,000. No matter what the outcome is, if you win the second game as well, then you have a chance at a grand total of $25,000. Let me repeat it. First game, you try for $10,000. If you win twice, you go over there and try and win $25,000. The subjects are all over here on the board. I'll review them. And Constance, I'll ask you to pick one out in a second. First one up there is, If I Were a Rich Man, The Lovebirds, Wine, Women, and Song, Open Wide, Run for Your Life, It's All Frills. And Constance, what strikes your fancy, if anything?
Something tells me I should take Run for Your Life.
Run for Your Life.
I don't know why.
No, don't be pessimistic. Now, you remember how this works. You have a little private screen there. You'll have 30 seconds. You are to describe for your partner, in this case, these things associated with running. Things associated with running. Now, stand by. Ready? Go.
Not the night, but the...
Day.
No, early.
Morning.
The sweat on your face is you...
Perspiration.
Take it.
In the morning, you get ready to run, so you do these things.
Stretches.
The distance that you run is a...
A mile.
The thing that you wear is your...
Jogging suit?
No, all the one piece... piece...
Warm-ups.
Is called a...
Sweat?
When you run one of these races, like in Boston or New York...
Marathon.
You get a cramp in your leg.
Oh, you got 5 out of 7. A little trouble with outfit. Little smidgen of outfit came out, which reminds me, the good old cuckoo has never left this over all these years. If you have a little follow-up along the way for you, in that case, read part of the answer or give an inappropriate clue. It goes, boop, boop, and then we're talking, yes, I hear you, fool. All right, it's 5-0.
I always thought you did that.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Which one of these would you like?
Wine, Women, and Song.
All right. Please describe for your partner these things associated with wine. Janet, stand by for things associated with wine. Ready? Go.
What it comes in.
A bottle.
Where it's stored.
In the cellar.
The foreign country that it comes from.
France.
Where you put them.
Cases, yeah. Racks, wine racks.
It contains the stuff that makes you drunk.
Alcohol.
A white wine.
Chardonnay.
White
Chardonnay.
Wine.
Chardonnay, Chablis.
Yes. The thing you pour it from, pour it in and then pour
decanter.
It out of, yes.
You got it, 7 out of 7. Perfect score. Scott, they've stepped ahead of you a little bit by a couple of points, but all is not lost. You can pick it up here. Which one would you like, sir?
I think we'll go with open wide.
Open wide, all right. Let's see. Describe for Constance these things that go into the mouth, but they are not eaten. Things that go into the mouth, but they are not eaten. Ready? Go.
Okay, this is to take your temperature.
Thermometer.
This is chewing.
Gum.
This is what you would smoke.
Pipe.
Dental.
Floss.
What a baby has.
Pacifier.
This is a Benny Goodman plated instrument.
Clarinet.
What a dentist gives you, a shot
Drill.
Of painkiller.
Oh, Novocaine.
That's it, you got them all. It's 12 to 7.
Great. I wish I gave it to you.
Nice race in the works here. Robert and Janet, you have If I Were a Rich Man, The Lovebirds, and It's All Frills. Janet, what would you like?
It's All Frills.
It's All Frills. Describe for your partner these things that are ornamental. Things that are ornamental. Ready? Go.
Okay, this is right here.
Ring.
This is this right here.
Hair.
It's when you put it in a little iron and up on a roller.
Curl.
Yes. Okay, this is what a bride wears.
Veil.
This is, you tie it.
Bow.
Yes. Okay. This is a Hawaiian.
Lei.
This is a rabbit or a jacket made
Shawl.
Out of. It's the
fur
material. Yes. Okay. This is a certain kind of potato chip has ridges, and it also is a
dip.
Potato chip has ridges.
The what?
Ruffle.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I was as stuck on that one as you were. The score is 13 to 12. You're ahead at the moment, Robert, so we'll give the choice to Scott and Constance. And what will it be, please?
I think we'll go with If I Were a Rich Man.
You may recall from times gone by, at this point, you have a chance to give or receive. You have the
screen? I think I will give.
All right, Constance, he's going to describe for you these things a millionaire has on his mind. Things a millionaire has on his mind. Ready? Go.
Okay, this would be his attorney. It would be
an accountant.
Someone who represents him in court.
Lawyer.
Okay, not sell, but...
Buy.
Okay, income?
Property.
What you paid Uncle Sam? Okay, not stocks, but...
Bonds.
Okay, this would be land, property?
Real estate.
Okay, not loss, but...
Gain.
What you make is
profit.
Your... Okay, not impotent, but...
Powerful.
You got it, 7 out of 7, man. Hopefully, run by very quickly the significance of this score. It's 19 to 13. Janet and Robert, in order to go over to the winner's circle and try for $10,000, you've got to come up with 7 out of 7. You've got to come up with 20 points in order to win this round. You've got the screen. Do you want to play it that way?
Mm-hmm.
Janet, describe for Robert these things in a love story. Things in a love story, they need 20 points. Ready? Go.
All right, not Romeo, but...
Juliet.
This is what you play
Violin.
Like this. This is a writing that Emily Dickens writes.
Novel.
And it rhymes.
A poem.
Yes. Okay, this is, you pluck the petals off of it.
Flower.
Loves you, loves me not. A particular kind of
Daisy.
Flower. Okay, this is, you're having a, with a person that's married, and so you...
Affair.
Yes, okay. This is what you put logs in and light it up.
Fireplace.
Yes, okay. And this is goodbye.
Farewell.
Yes.
You got it. Just in the nick of time. The clock has run to zero. You have a chance to try for $10,000. You'll be back to play again in a moment. Please come to the winner's circle. There was no time left. No, it's gone by the time you're here. All right. Now, congratulations.
Mom?
You've always known how your touch can comfort your...
Absolutely free. Call toll free now.
Make you feel better. All right, Janet, you got the magic rub down. Those fingers, those golden touches there. That's to supposedly relax you under this circumstance. Now, let me tell you what's happened. You won the first game. You're going to try for $10,000. To win it all, you've got to go to the top of the pyramid there. There's 6 subjects up there. We have 60 seconds. If you want to skip one, Robert, you recall, you can do it and then come back to it. If you get stuck, I may say, do you want to go on? That means the clock's running. I'm watching that. You're only allowed to give a list of the things that fit the subject. If you use your hands or inadvertently read the answer or make a mistake, you'll hear this sound. And don't stop to say, hey, what happened? We'll talk about it later.
Or how
you ready?
Ready.
Concentrate on your partner now. Stand by for $10,000. Here's your first subject. Go.
Sand.
Things,
towels.
Things on the beach.
I have these beautiful costumes and my piano and my candelabra.
I'm what Liberace would say.
Right.
Con Edison. Telephone. Rent.
Things that you have to pay, bills you pay.
Right.
Clocks. Go on.
Things that tick.
Yes.
You got it.
Go on. An egg. A joke.
Things that crack.
Yes.
Yes.
Library books.
Things you return.
Wine
you
bottles.
Borrow. Things you reuse.
Sexy girls.
Things that are used.
Wine bottles. Sexy girls. Library books.
Things that are set. Let's see, $2,455,6,750. Not a bad start. We'll change partners. Be back to play again right after this. That was close. Close.
800-236-23280.
Welcome back once again to the $25,000 pyramid, and I should point out now, Janet, that you've picked up $750. You're in mighty good company there, and if you win this round, we'll go on to try for $25,000. If Scott wins it, he will try for $10,000. I should point out one other thing. The person that accumulates the most money today will return again tomorrow to compete against another contestant. And there was one quick note here I wanted to ask you. Constance, you're a new mama?
Yes, I had a baby almost 4 months ago.
Oh, wow. Boy, girl?
I had a rather large boy.
And his name?
Is Daniel Morgan.
Much good luck with the young man. Much good luck to everybody here as we continue along. Let me repeat once again. You've won your first game. You're up to try for $25,000. Let me review the subjects here for all. We have What's His Name, Calm Down, Touch and Go, Fun for All, Think Thin, Mystery 7, and Robert and Scott, we're going to turn to you for your choice.
What's his name?
What's his name it is, all right? When we get to that Mystery 7, it's a tad late, but that's a sneaker in there. I'm going to tell you about it after we play this round, okay? As quickly as you can, describe for your partner, these people are characters who are known by just one name. These are people or characters who are known by just one name. Ready? Go.
First man. Not Eve, but...
Adam.
The monster...
Frankenstein.
The little dog, cartoon dog.
A lassie?
No, cartoon dog.
Toto?
Snip. Go on, we'll come back to him. The Hawaiian TV show now.
Magnum.
Yes. She killed herself with an asp.
Cleopatra.
The frog.
Kermit.
Perone's mistress.
Eva. Evita.
We'll take it. All right, that's 6 out of 7 there. One of the things that I did not mention to you if you're watching at home that my friends here in the studio know, so let me review it for the folks at home. The Mystery 7 is a bit of a new twist here on the $25,000 pyramid. Pretty much you call out a category and I'll give you something, some help about what it is along the way. The Mystery 7 is somewhat of a bonus. You will not know what's behind that category. I won't tell you it's things having to do with anything. However, if you get 7 out of 7 today, you win a trip to Hawaii for 2, if you select that. But you don't know. You're going in sort of blind. It's like a carrot hung out in front of your nose. Ladies, with that sales pitch, do you want that one or some other one?
I think we should calm down first.
All right, fair enough. After all of that, I didn't sell that to you. Constance, describe these things you do when you are nervous. Things you do when you're nervous. Ready? Go.
Alcohol.
You drink.
Laugh a lot. Small laughs.
Giggle.
Turn red in the face.
Blush.
Walk up and down the floor when the baby's
pace.
About to be born. You make
Gulp.
A sound with your... move around in your seat when you're little.
Fidget.
Another word sounds
you're
like...
nervous.
No, sounds like a long, skinny thing that cuts into sections. It's an animal. You walk out, go...
centipede.
Go ahead, pass.
Squirm!
Yes, shaking all over. Oh, gosh.
Shudder.
No,
shudder.
Shaking.
All right, now... Constance, I want to refresh you on a rule that I'm sure you've forgotten a long time ago. Do not use sound likes. We cannot accept that as a clue. It's all tied up 6-6. Robert and Scott on deck now, and Scott, it's your choice.
I think we'll go with the Mystery 7.
Oh, a sport. Now, normally I say describe to your partner as quickly as you can these things having to do with so-and-so. I can't tell you that information. You may tie it all together as you go along. They all have something in common, but you're flying blind now. If you get 7 out of 7, it's a trip for 2 to Hawaii. Ready? And go.
Okay, it's not mayonnaise, but it's... You put on a hot dog?
Mustard.
Okay, a state in the southeastern. It's a peninsula, large.
Florida.
Okay, not the moon, but the...
Sun.
Okay, it's a bright burst of light.
Flash.
Okay, a car has a...
Engine.
Okay, what you go in, it's a wood room. You sweat in it.
Sauna.
Okay, kind of Mexican food.
Taco, chili... pepper.
It's made with corn husks.
Hot tamales!
You said the magic word, hot. They were all hot, and the last one was tamales. One more, you would have had a trip to Hawaii. You have a substantial lead, though. It's 12-6. Ladies on deck, which one will it be?
Think thin.
Think thin it is. Describe for your partner these things associated with a diet. Things associated with a diet. Ready? Okay. Go.
All right, this is rabbits eat them.
Vegetables.
No, a
lettuce.
No.
Oh, carrots.
Yes, okay. This is not slow, but
fast.
Okay, this is a kind of a fish that comes in a can.
Sardines.
No, Charlie.
Anchovies.
Charlie.
Tuna.
Yeah, okay. This is a type of a diet. It's here today, gone tomorrow.
Fad.
Yes, okay. This is a sauna, and you go and you work out there.
Steam room.
No, it's the whole,
gym.
No, okay, go on. This is your
All right, it's 12 to 10, ladies. That means you have the last choice. Janet and Constance, we have touch and go. Fun for all. Ladies, what will it be?
Fun for all.
Do you want to give or receive?
It's up to you.
I'll give.
Okay, describe for Constance these things that people enjoy. Things that people enjoy. Ready? Go.
Okay, this is a present.
Gift.
Yes. This is a back rub.
Massage.
Yes. This is making love. Small word for it.
Sex.
Yes. Okay, this is a an interest that you have. You collect
Hobby.
Stamps. Okay, this is, you look nice today.
Compliment.
This is, if you go on vacation, you take a...
Suitcase.
Christmas is a...
Holiday.
Yes, okay. This is a wild...
Party.
No, I'm gonna throw
Affair.
It... No.
It's a fling she was looking for. The score is 16 to 12. Ladies, if you can hold on to that lead, you, Janet, will try for $25,000. Scott, if you come up with 17 points, you'll try for $10,000. You're going to give or receive?
I'd like to give.
Describe for your partner these things that are operated with the fingers. Things that are operated with the fingers. They need 17. Ready? Go.
Okay, this is on your pants. You pull it out.
Zipper.
Okay, this is you unlock the door
Key.
With. Okay, this is on the phone.
Dial.
Okay, this is a pocket. You
calculate
little things up. Okay, this would be what an angel plays.
Harp.
Okay, this is a...
You got it, guys. You won it. Won it by a point. Let's go to the winner's circle and try for $10,000.
Know what I used to hate about hairspray? Everything, especially...
Apex Street Department GS, Nashville, Tennessee.
Scott, you've won the game. You have a chance to win $10,000 now. If you win in excess of $750, the person who wins the most money will return. You know the rules. I won't take any time because we're short. Stand by. Here's your first subject. Go!
Your belt, your wallet,
articles of clothing,
your
things
shoes.
Made of leather.
Oh, I'm so sick. I'm just always sick. I have these pains.
Things,
I have these
things a hypochondriac.
Right. The ribbon. The keys, the platen,
the things that are given to someone in...
The ribbon, the keys, the platen.
A typewriter, parts
right.
of a typewriter.
Van Gogh.
Artists, painters, abstract
on,
artists.
Go on,
next,
go
please.
Go on, next. Money.
Things people save.
Oh, your identification.
Things that are kept in a wallet.
Your address, your phone number.
Personal
your
things. Things that identify you.
Go on. Milk.
Things that are drunk.
Morning milk.
Okay.
Oh,
things
oh I'm sorry. Gentlemen, turn around.
Yes.
Things that are delivered. Men with a beard. Things that change. You picked up $200, $300. We'll be back to summarize right after this.
When you have a kid, there is...
Citizen Juvenile Jury. Enjoy.
Well, folks, that's our first go-round with a $25,000 pyramid. Let me summarize ever so quickly here. Money figures here. Scott, you won, I think, $300. You won $750. Jenna, that means you return again tomorrow. Robert, thank you very much. We'll see you then. Thank you, my dear, for now. Good talk. So long.
Some of our contestants will receive the Bissell Double Action Force Sweeper snaps up dirt and litter on carpet and bare floors. Great to pick up some clean vacuuming from Bissell. And Heat Bits of Brickle adds great almond toffee flavor to just about every dessert, especially Bits of Brickle ice cream pie. And 4 gallons of trouble with 2-test easy care latex spot wall and trim finish for walls and woodwork only at True Value Hardware stores. And Heath Candy Bar's rich almond coffee covered with real milk chocolate. The great taste of Heath that speaks for itself. And Quoizel presents this hand-blown crystal lamp from the satin lace collection, designed to add beauty and warmth to your home exclusively by Quoizel Lighting. And try renewed and adjustable air pressure for all over your house. The long-lasting pressure that costs less than most. Renews it, does it.
Talking about on Child's Play. Here is the host of Child's Play, Bill Cullen.
Oh, thank you. What a nice group. What a marvelous bunch of nuts. Thank you. And welcome to Child's Play. It's a game for grown-ups. We're going to meet the children in Child's Play in just a moment, but first, why do we not say hello to the grown-ups? First of all, sitting over there is Dawn Miller. I think you're sitting, are you, Dawn?
Oh, yes.
Or a short person, are you? This is Child's Play, Dawn. Tell us about your kids.
Well, I have four children. I have a 6-year-old boy and twin boys that are 5 and a very mischievous 2-year-old daughter.
Twins who are 5.
Yes.
Across from her, to her right, is Trudy Staples. Hello, Trudy.
Hello, Trudy.
Child's Play, tell us about children in your life.
I also have 4 children.
Well, it's a tie score.
I have Zachary 9 and Sarah Beth is 7. I have Abigail 5 and Maggie 3.
You're from Massachusetts, are you? You both have 4 children. The rules of the show is the first of you who has 5 wins the game and automatically goes.
We're going to get started. Yeah.
If you're ready, if they're ready to go, we're ready to go. So let us get set to play Child's Play. Now, we took our Child's Play cameras and aimed them at children in the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd grades, 5 to 9 years of age. We gave them some everyday words and asked each child to tell us in his own way what that word means. Now, we're going to show you several children defining the same word, and you can take a guess after you've listened to each child. Now, we're going to start the guessing with you, Dawn, over there. Now, first, let's show the audience the word you're playing for. Okay, the audience knows. Now, coming up is Shayna Lee Farrell. She's 5 and a half from New York City, and here's the way she describes the word.
Like, I sometimes wear my mommy's nightgowns and my mommy's shoes, and sometimes I put on my Wonder Woman bathing suit. Sometimes I make myself look like a fairy or a bad witch.
Okay, now the audience knows what you're trying for, but you don't. And Dawn, you get the first guess. What do you think the word is?
Dress up.
Dress up. No, that is not the right answer. So now, Trudy, you're going to get a chance to make a guess at the very same word. Same word being described. And here's Seth Wagerman from Los Angeles. He's 8, and he's going to describe it to you.
Okay. For Halloween, I might get into a ghost outfit, and then I'd say, hey, Mom, how do I look? Is this a good... Or I might... I might walk around and I might find this funny person. He looks like a zombie wearing this white headband. Or he might have had his nose plastered. That's a kind of one. He might have had his face plastered to make it look different. That's a little more, you know. And I'd say, what are you doing? He said, well, I just put on a... to make me look different.
Now, based on that, Seth Wagerman, let it go. Based on what you heard, Trudy, what do you think the word is?
I think it's costume.
No, it is not costume. Would you believe that? All right, final definition coming up, and it's back to you, Dawn. Now, here's Heather Chapman, 7.5 years old. She's from Los Angeles. Same word, here's her description.
Like, if you have, like, a face that, like, if you're a bank robber or something, if you have a face that somebody's going to recognize, like, if they have a warrant out for you or something, like a reward, like, of money or something for you, if they catch you, then, like, they put it, like, they have, like, masks, or you can buy them at a toy store, like, you put fake mustache on and all that, and then you won't look like your regular thing, so you can go ahead and rob all the banks you want, and they won't even know.
So, Dawn, you've heard 3 descriptions. Heather's is the latest. What do you think the word is for a point?
I was going to say mask.
And you said?
But she said that. I can't think. I'm just blank.
Okay. I will then tell you what that word is. Now, the audience knows here. Trudy, you probably have it by now. The word is disguise.
Oh,
okay, we'll be back here with a new word, but right now we have this for you. Okay, we're back now. Let's get set for a new word. And this time we're going to start with you, Dawn, again, because the last one was not guessed correctly. First, let's show the new word to the folks at home. Okay, there it is. People here in the studio know what it is. Here's Juliana Stefanoff, 7.5 years old, from New York City, and here's the way she describes this word.
That they go to church about every day. They wear special kinds of clothes. Some of the people wear a black outfit with some weight on their collar. They have this white, big black hat, and some of them have glasses on and have little curls down from their head. And they have ponytails and they're men.
The audience obviously liked that definition. Dawn, what do you say the word is?
The way she describes it, I'm going to have to say none.
No. The nuns who have ponytails and are men. Yes. Boy, things have changed since my last spanking. Trudy, this one is all for you. Now, I want you to listen closely to this definition. Same word. It's Bart Sayer, 7 years old, from New York.
That means, like suppose you were Jewish or Christian or Canadian or what, respond to holidays, you do things, you believe in Santa Claus, and you go trick or treating.
He said, I don't know if you heard it, he ended up by saying, or you go trick or treating. Remember
that
this is a child's mind. Trudy, you have a guess. What do you think the word is?
A priest.
No, it is not a priest. We are back to you, Dawn, and we have the final definition of this word. Try to think like a child. Try to think like Terry Ann Bradley, 7 years old, from New York City. Terry Ann.
Catholic's one. Jewish is one. Muslim is one. And Buddhism is one. It's when you believe in a god or you believe in a goddess. You hear the history of this person, like the way Moses led the apostles.
All right. You don't have to believe everything you hear, Dawn, but what do you say? What do you say the word is?
Religion.
Religion is the right answer. That's the way it works. That's right. That's right. Now, that gives you a point. We play Child's Play until time is up, and whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a chance at $5,000. Okay, we're going to come up with a new word, and because you got it, Dawn, once again, we're going to begin with you. This word is going to be described by, first there's for the audience, of course. Now, Marissa Goldstein, 7 years old, from Los Angeles, tells you what she thinks it is.
It's when two people love each other and they hug each other and stuff, and they like go to school with each other and they dance at parties with each other and stuff like that. They do anything together, go to movies together. Yeah.
That is it as far as it goes. Dawn, it's your guess. What do you think?
This is kind of embarrassing, but I'd say sex.
Well, I don't know how you feel, but it sure embarrassed me. But anytime you want to say sex, step right up. Trudy, listen carefully because we have Justin Caswin, 6.5 years old from Los Angeles. Same word.
That means to kiss and hug and make love.
In spite of Justin's reaction, we know it's not sex. What do you think it is, Trudy?
Romance.
Romance is the right answer. Romance, sure. Yeah. Sort of a mild form of sex. Anyway.
She's got 4 kids.
We have a tied-up game, one for Trudy and one for Dawn. Trudy, you're going to begin. Listen carefully because we're going to show this next word to our audience here in the studio and the folks at home. And this is Eric Yale Vaught, my favorite person in the world. He's from Los Angeles, and here's his description.
That's easy. It's money, but it's the color. And you can use it as, like, there are little chips of it. You use money out of it. And if you find it, boy, you're rich. It's worth, like, $100 or $1,000.
Great. You got Eric Yale Vaught's description. What do you think the word is?
Well, if I found a bunch of silver, would I be rich? Is it silver?
No, you wouldn't. No. It is not silver. And Dawn, you're going to get a chance. Remember that description and listen to this one by Justin Lunan Pack from New York City.
It's like when they're, like, it's pretty expensive. It's sort of a yellow color. It's yellow shiny. And it's a kind of metal. And it's pretty soft. So usually when you buy it in a ring or on a bracelet, there's like copper in with it. And like 14 carat has a certain amount of copper in it. And 18 carat doesn't have as much copper in it. And 18 carat is more expensive than 14 carat. More of the yellow shiny stuff.
With that, with that description, Dawn, there's nowhere to go but up. What do you say the word is?
Give me 14 karat gold.
Gold is the right answer, Dawn. You have a point. The score right now, 2 points for Dawn, 1 point for Trudy, and here comes
Hey, there's the school bell, and that signals the end of this round of Child's Play. The score, Dawn 2, Trudy 1. When we come back to Child's Play, we're going to shift gears and play the game for speed in the Fast Play round. We'll be back with Fast Play, but right now, wouldn't you watch this, please? As they say, let me ask you one question. How do you like our kids so far? I've learned to respect the younger generation. It's time now, as we promised you, for Fast Play. Now, we're going to show you a series of children, each child defining a different word. As soon as either of you recognize the word, interrupt with your signal. If you're right, you will win an additional point. Whichever player is ahead when the game is over, time runs out, wins $500 for the game and a chance at $5,000. All right, now ready to use your signals to interrupt. We're not going to show the audience these words. That's so they can play along with us. Okay, if you're ready, here's Lisa Coven with your first Fast Play word.
Something that's above your legs and your arms are attached to it and your head, your neck is...
What do you think it is, Trudy?
Your shoulders.
No, it is not your shoulders. That's the wrong answer. We're going to repeat the entire definition for you, Dawn, and then you have a chance to guess on
okay.
your own. Hear out the entire definition. Here's Lisa Coven to do it all again for you.
Something that's above your legs and your arms are attached to it, and your head, your neck is, and... your belly button is on it, and it's opposite of your back.
Dawn?
Chest.
With a belly button on it?
Well, I thought because she said your arms were attached to it.
Sure, and your belly button, too.
Stomach.
Actually, that's right. The actual answer was stomach. We're coming up with another one. Ready to interrupt with your signals now. Hey, that school bell means we're coming into the home stretch. What we're going to do now is double the point score. 2 points for every correct answer, so Trudy, you should be able to catch up. Person ahead when time's up wins the $500 and a chance to play for $5,000. Ready with your interrupt signals there. Brandon Stevenson with our next word.
Well, you could put it in coffee. It's in a lot of food.
What do you think?
Sugar.
Sugar is the right answer, right. Dawn. That's a 2-point win for you. Dawn, you have 4. Trudy, you have 1. The points are doubling. Next word coming up. Ready with your signals? David Almagor with the next word. David.
It's like a thing that comes from a boat, and you put it down to stop it.
You're first, Trudy, for double points.
Anchor.
Anchor's right. That's 2 points for you. You double, and you're up to 3. Next one coming up. Both of you ready with your signals? Here's Terry and Bradley.
Well, this word means that my aunt and uncle had this because they were married 25 years, and my grandpa...
What do you say it is?
Anniversary.
Anniversary is the right answer, Dawn. Double point. Score is 6 for Dawn and 3 for you, Trudy. Okay, a reminder. Hey, there's that bell again, and that's it. With a score of 6-3, the winner is Dawn Miller. Congratulations, Dawn. Come on over here. I'm going to give you a shot at another $5,000. Come on over here. There you go. Congratulations to you. Hey, Trudy, you played a beautiful game. Thank you for being with us. We had some very nice parties.
You're
welcome. Now, how are you doing?
Terrific. Thank you.
Thank you, Trudy.
Thank you.
Very nice one for you. Now, we're going to give you, Dawn Miller, a chance to win $5,000. But right now, we're going to ask you to watch this with us, okay?
Okay.
Here we go. Well, with 4 kids of your own and the help of these, you've just won $500, Dawn.
Right.
And now it's time to try for the $5,000 in our triple play game. Now, this time, and listen carefully, we asked our Child's Play kids to write brief definitions of simple words. We took 3 definitions per word, each one written by a different child, A, B, or C. Some are far out, some are right on the nose. You'll never know until you've picked definition A, B, or C. You will have a total of 45 seconds to get 6 words. We pay you $100 a word, and if you get them all, that's when you win the $5,000. Now remember, these definitions were written by children. Okay, keep that in mind. Bring in the clock. Time will start when you pick your first letter. You ready to go? Here we go.
B.
Something you need when you make a mistake.
Eraser.
Right. Pick.
B.
It two dots at the end of your smile.
Dimples.
Dimple, right. Next word. Take one.
B.
An oriental country.
Japan.
Take another.
A.
Bruce Lee was born there.
China.
China's right. Take one.
C.
A hard kind of music and a hard stone.
B.
A giant pebble.
Rock.
Rock is right. Take another one.
A.
It means something is made of glass.
Breakable.
No, take another
B.
one.
B.
It could be an antique vase that would break easily.
C.
Something that has to be taken care of when it is carried.
Next word.
Next word. Pick one.
B.
A private book you write.
Diary.
Diary is right. You got diary as time expired, and you have five correct at $100 apiece. That's another.
Yay, thank you. Thank you.
Not bad.
I'll take it.
Okay, stay right here. Okay. You got.
All right.
Just.
Yeah.
Well, one of the clues, you have to be very careful when you carry it. It breaks easily. Fragile, we were looking for. But you got yourself five at $100 a piece. That's a total of $1,000. And you'll be back here again next time to take on a new challenger and have another try at $5,000. Dawn and I will be back here in just a moment. But right now, wouldn't you please watch this? Hey, Dawn, you did all right. You have $1,000. How's that?
That's terrific. It's $250 per child.
Be sure to join us next time when she tries to win another $5,000. That's a lot per kid. Hey, if you like kids, you'll love Child's Play. Goodbye. We'll see you next time. See ya.
Double the action.
Yes, baby.
Game's on now.
Double the money.
$100,000 bet.
Double the deception.
Ain't bluffing fun.
It is when you get away with it.
Double the trash talk.
I just can't believe how poorly you guys play.
You people are so sick. I love it.
2 solid hours of the only real cash game on TV. High stakes poker. 2 solid hours starting Monday night at 8, followed by World Series of Blackjack at 10, only on GSN.
School bell means we're coming into the home stretch. What we're going to do now is double the point score. 2 points for every correct answer. So, Trudy, you should be able to catch up. Person ahead when time's up wins the $500 and a chance to play for $5,000. Ready with your interrupt signals there. Brandon Stevenson with our next word.
Well, you could put it in coffee. It's in a lot of food.
What do you think?
Sugar.
Sugar is the right.
Now, look at it this way. If you're the number 2 cola or number 3 or number 7, nobody cares how you compare to number 29, right? So, they've done challenges and taste tests and comparisons against Coca-Cola. And maybe that's why Coke is called the real thing. It's got real refreshment, a real big taste. If you're number 2 or number 3 or number 7 or number 29, you know what you want to be when you grow up. Yes, Coke is it. Huh? You're nodding. Yes, that's right. You would like this. Coke is it.
Francis Vargas, come on down. Graciela Saba, come on down. Gerald Levin. Come on down! And Sheila wins! Come on down! You are the first 4 contestants on The Prize is Right! And now, here's the star of The Price is Right, Bob Barker.
you. Now, you are all very warm and you're welcome, but these three ladies right back here actually gave me a standing ovation. They were on their feet. Therefore, and for that reason, you get the first three prizes on the show. Now, what are the first three prizes? I'll think up something. Right now, one of you four will win this first item up for bids, and the price is right.
A new trampoline. A trampoline with a unique round design for outdoor fun and recreation. Ideal for physical fitness with features such as uniform bounce, larger jumping area from round trampoline.
We're going to present that trampoline to the one of you who bids nearest to the actual retail price without going over. Sheila, what do you bid?
$400.
$400. Gerald, let's hear from you.
$700.
He says $700. Graciela.
$500.
$500, and now Francis.
$450.
$450. And the actual retail price of the trampoline is $828. You win, Gerald! Turn me around here a little bit. Where do you live?
North Dakota, Hatton, North Dakota.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
What do you do up in North Dakota?
Well, I farm and sell real estate.
Mm-hmm.
Coach girls softball.
Oh, you do?
I'm retired now.
You're a busy guy. Now, you're retired, so you've come down here to Southern California on a vacation.
To enjoy the sunshine.
Yes. Today, the day that we are taping this show, there is a very heavy fog here in Southern California. In parts of the country, they would call it rain. But you're enjoying Southern California anyway.
Very much so.
You're going to enjoy it even more if you win the prize that I have to offer you. Gerald, look at this little souvenir of Southern California.
A new car! This is the handsome Ford Mustang that comes with power brakes, AM/FM stereo radio, reclining seats, P175 VSW tires, California emission, and all the other standard options. This one comes with floor mats and speed control. Okay, Bob?
Yes, we're going to play Lucky 7. Did you get this? Oh, the steering wheel was locked. I could tell by the look on her face as she came out here that she was not a happy driver. And the steering wheel was locked, and if she hadn't stopped it, she would have gone right through these doors here. Now, we're going to play Lucky 7. There are the seven $1 bills. You end up with one of those, and I'll sell you that car for that $1. Tell me, what is the first number in the price of this car?
Six.
He says that's a six. Is that a six? It's a seven. $1. What's the next number?
Four.
He says it's a four. Show us. It's a four, Jeff. Third number in the price for the car.
Five.
Gerald says it's a five. Open that door, please. Oh, that's good. Gerald, you have $5 left. Now, you can miss this. You have to have $1 to buy the car.
Right.
So you can miss this by four, one way or the other. What do you want? He has... Just look at that.
It's crazy.
I have never seen so many faces going, five, five, five. Well, it just so happens that Gerald took five. What is the number? It's a one. That'll cost you $4. And you have a dollar left. Trying to snicker me out of that last dollar, I do believe. We'll be back with our next game after this message. Who do you have for us now, John?
Bob, I have Kathryn Ann Washabaugh. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Kathryn Ann, I welcome you to contestant's row.
Will you bring out the next item up for bids, please? It's a brass coat rack. From Wesley Allen, a rose coat rack with three legs, a family heirloom from the first day of ownership, fashioned from pure brass, finely detailed hand craftsmanship. The finish requires no polishing. From Wesley Allen.
Hit on that, Kathy Ann.
$425.
She says $425. What do you say, Graciela?
$300.
$300 to Francis.
$250.
$250. Sheila.
$350.
She says $350. And I say the actual retail price is $280. Francis, join me. Francis, I want you to win this. A player piano. It's Cabaret from the Aeolian Corporation. You can play it manually or it'll play for you electrically. The whole bunch of musical fun, the Cabaret Player Piano by Aeolian. And it's a prize worth $3,940. We're going to play Hit Me, which is just like blackjack. Cut the cards, will you please, Francis? Cut the cards. Diane, will you take the cards over there and draw the top card? That will be the hole card for the house. Then Diane will draw the second card. That'll be the up card for the house. The house hits at 16 and stays on 17 and everything above. Has a two up. That's good. That's a bad card. The house doesn't have a very good hand. You may win this game. Now, John, what are the products in the Hit Me game today?
Well, first, Bob, Soft Sense is the new skin lotion with oil-free softeners that don't feel greasy. With Soft Sense, all you feel is soft. Kraft Macaroni and Cheese Dinner is the only one with their exclusive cheddar cheese sauce recipe. It's made with Kraft Cheddar. What could be better? Legs wide band, knee highs, and two pair egg with reinforced toe. Wide band covered, nothing beats a great pair of legs. There's only one way to describe wilderness fruit fillings. They're so fresh, you'll think you picked them yourself. Discover the taste of Jolly Time, the much better popcorn. Always light, crisp, delicious. Next time, make it Jolly Time. And Search has flavor crystals for great taste. And Search with Retsin keeps on freshening your breath even after an hour.
Now, we want you to get 21 without going over. Why don't you pick out a product you believe is the actual price multiplied by 10? That would be a good start.
The certs.
The certs? Where are the certs? Where are the certs? The certs are right here. $13.90? That can't be the price, can it? Of course not. What is the price? $1.39. It is a multiple of 10. Now, pick out a product that is the exact price. That'll be a 1, which you can use as a 1, or an 11. If you get that, you'd have 21. You'd win the game.
The exact price, the nylons.
The nylons? Where are the nylons? Where are the nylons? Right down here. $3.18, and the actual price, $1.59. That's a multiple of 2. So you have 12. Now what are you going to do, Francis? You know that you can stay anytime you want to, just like blackjack. You've played blackjack.
Right.
Okay, what do you want now?
I want the exact price.
Well, you have 12, and you don't want to go over 21. The best thing you could get is the price multiplied by 9, but...
Popcorn.
The what?
Popcorn.
The popcorn. The popcorn is $4.56. The actual price is 57 cents, which is a multiple of 8. You have 20. You're going to stay now. Yeah, she says, I'm going to stay. Okay. She has 20. What's the house's whole card? The house's whole card is 6, so draw a card. We have 8. Now we have 17, and the house stays on 17. So we're through, and you win. Congratulations. You're a good player. There you go. We have 2 games. You have 2 winners. Are we going to have another big day? Think so. Be back after these words. I'll bet a lot of you folks here in our Price is Right office remember that popular show Tattletales, don't you? Remember Tattletales? It's one of my favorite shows. Well, I got good news for you. CBS has brought Tattletales back to the network. More good news. My good friend Bert Convy is going to host it again. Yeah.
So I want all of you to watch Tattletales, and you too, and make old Bert happy. All right, John, you're going to make somebody happy, aren't you? Who will it be?
Bob, it's going to be Patricia Schultz. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Prize is Right.
You see, Patricia has on her fog coat today because, as I said, it's a little foggy in California. We have the next item up for bids coming out on the Price is Right train.
A new microwave oven. Oh,
my God, what an oven!
A Tappan microwave oven. This Tappan test model features 6 automatic memory levels, an automatic temperature probe, which senses the interior temperature of food, and the probe turns the oven off as you wish from Tappan.
Patricia, what do you bid on that oven?
$451.
Sheila, what do you bid?
Bob, $400.
$400 to Kathy Ann.
$475.
$475. Graciela.
$500.
$500. The actual retail price is $490. You win, Kathy Ann. Here she is. Thank you. Open the doors and show her the prizes, please.
A bar set and a pair of recliners. First, from Chromecraft, this 2-stool bar set with a clear glass top on a rattan base and the shining brass stools are upholstered in a rust fantasy fabric. Yours for charming entertaining from Chromecraft. And second, the Monique Rocker Recliners, soft comfort combined with unique styling with elegant highlighted velvet, makes these Rocker Recliners a beautiful accent for living room or den, relaxing style from Easy Rest Incorporated.
And she tells me that she pronounces her name just plain Catherine.
Catherine.
Well, I still pronounce mine just plain Bob. Okay? Now, I want you to know that both of these are bargain prices, $5.95 and $6.78. One is a bigger bargain. One is more below the actual retail price. Tell me which one will give you both. You say this is the bigger bargain. So we'll start with these chairs over here. Bargain price, $6.78. Actual price, $9.78 for a difference of $300. Now over here. Bargain price, $5.95. Actual retail price, $1,095. A difference of $500. You win both the prizes. Showcase showdown after this
match. Showdown!
Thank you, John. The contestant who is nearest to $1 on the big wheel without going over ends up in the showcase on The Price is Right. $1 exactly in one spin or a combination of two spins, $1,000 reward and a bonus spin. And if the wheel stops on one of the two green sections in the bonus spin, it's worth $5,000 more. $10,000 if it stops on the $1 in the bonus spin. Who's doing all this spinning? You three are doing all this spinning. That's who's doing all this spinning. Are you going to spin first?
Yeah.
Step over there, Catherine, and do it. Go, Catherine, someone said. Someone who wants to be taken to lunch, doubtlessly. Catherine, that has a chance at getting around here to $1, I think. Well, a little more pizzazz. Then you might have done it. 25 cents. Are you through spinning? You're going to go to the bin? Go right ahead. 25 cents in her first spin. This is spin number 2 for Catherine. And in spin number 2, Catherine has... Hey, look at that, 75 cents. You win $1,000. You win $1,000. You get a bonus spin, too. You'll have your bonus spin after our other two contestants have spun. You were in a hot streak today. We had all three games won. Already we've given away $1,000. Spin that wheel, Francis. Now that has to go all the way around. Now wait, it may make it. It made it. It got all the way around. They're booing because they thought you wouldn't get it all the way around.
55. Spin it again. Now spin it hard. Okay, you got 55 cents, and you have to tie $1. 55 cents plus 45, that's not going to get around here again. Francis, the 45 just went by, and I'm afraid you're all through. But thanks for being with
us. Thank you.
Bye-bye. All right, Gerald the farmer from North Dakota, the real estate, go ahead, spin the wheel, real estate broker in North Dakota, the girls' softball team coach in North Dakota. You do anything else in North Dakota?
No, but now that I got the car from here, we're going to Las Vegas, so I could use the money.
All right, very good. Let's hope that you can get yourself a dollar. You have 95 cents to start. Spin it again. Spin it again. Get yourself a nickel. One nickel is what he is looking for. Now, there goes the nickel, and I'm afraid it's not going to make it again. But I hope you enjoy that car.
I do very much.
Bye-bye. Now, you heard what I said. The green sections are worth $5,000. The dollar is worth $10,000. Now, let me point out that you get only one spin, and if it doesn't go all the way around, it doesn't count, and you don't get to spin again. So spin hard. Here we go. Now, that could be interesting. That could be interesting. Here it comes down here again. Hurry up. Come on. It quit on us, but you've won $1,000. You're going to be in the showcase, and we'll be back after these. What do you have to tell us?
I have a name, Bob Barker. It's Roger Gay. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Roger, get into that vacant spot and contest your show and have a look at the next item up for bid from The Price is Right.
It's a presidential telephone. From Paul Nelson Industries, enjoy a jelly bean while making a call to your favorite politician. Beautifully done in red, white, blue with a golden eagle atop from Paul Nelson Industries.
Roger, what do you bid on that telephone?
I can't see too well.
$250.
He says $350?
$250.
$250. $250 it is. Graciela, what do you say?
$200.
$200. Now, Patricia.
$195.
$195. Sheila, what do you bid?
$150.
She bids $150. That telephone is $359. Roger is the winner. Roger, we have a spot for winners on the stage. To be more specific, let us hear about the range game. Howdy, Roger. Let's show Roger another prize.
A hand-carved armoire. This armoire is a provincial two-door flat top and pickled pine finish. It stands 6 feet, 3 inches tall. Four movable shelves, a decorator piece you'd be proud to display.
And Roger, the $150 rangefinder will move slowly up the scale. When you believe the price of that prize is in the red area, press that button. If you're right, Roger, you win the prize. Now step over there and don't press that button until you want to stop the rangefinder. Start that rangefinder up the scale for Roger, will you please? Starting down there at 1600, to go up over 1700, 1800, and so on. You let it go until you think the price is in the red area. Now don't press the button until you want to stop. Right back over here. I hear a smattering of booing out there. Now, just wait, just wait. They may be sorry. Light up that price. Oh, they're right. They're up there at $19.95. Roger, thank you for playing the range game. Well, we finally had a loser. But we've had two winners out of four, and there's more prices right coming up.
Stay tuned for more pricing games and the fabulous showcases coming up on the second half of The Price is Right.
Johnny Olsen, can you find me another player?
please.
Our Can Bob Barker is going to be Jamie Shorten.
Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Friday Drive. Hi, Jamie.
Hi.
Welcome to Contestant's Row. Do you suppose there's something for us to bid on right over here?
A new refrigerator. A Kelvinator no-frost refrigerator with generous 4.6 cubic foot freezer, meat keeper, trim wall insulation, and ice maker capability from Kelvinator, one of the white consolidated industries.
Jamie, I want you to bid first on that.
Okay. 800.
$800. Graciela.
$525.
$525. Patricia.
$750.
$750, and we go to Sheila.
$1,000.
Very well. This is a very responsive audience, you know that? When you're not happy, you let them know. The actual retail prize is $680, and you win Graciela. Do you really?
Yes.
Every single day. That's the nicest thing I can hear. Thank you very much. Where do you live?
In Salt Lake City.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
And you watch every day up in Salt?
Every day.
Well, that's just fine.
I feed my baby every day at that time, so I gotta watch it.
That's good. Now, since you watch every day, nothing would please me more than to be able to give you that.
A new car! This two-door Chevette hatchback economy car comes with four-cylinder AM radio, body-side molding, tinted glass, cloth coat, sound seal, and California emission. This one comes with tinted glass, power brakes, and automatic transmission. Bob?
No, you do watch. You know, all she saw, she's still not seen the game, and all she saw was the fact that they've brought out more prizes here. She said, oh, this is a hard game. And I said, what game is this? She said, it's switcheroo, and that's what it's going to be. And in this game, you can win these prizes, too.
Crayola Drawing Desk, with everything children need for hours of imaginative play. It's fun to create with Crayola. Bissell's revolutionary new sweeper, the Century 2, cleans to the walls and around furniture with unique corner brushes, sweeps all floor surfaces from Bissell. This compact, lightweight GE knife slices at any angle. Stainless steel blades have serrated cutting edges. The fingertip control bar has a safety lock. Wall mounting rack is included. And this is the Seth Thomas Fireside Quartz Mantle Clock in a classic tambour wood case with walnut finish and white dial with black numbers. Precision quartz accuracy. AA batteries not included.
And now here comes the switcheroo game for Graciela. And since you know all of this so well, why don't you tell me what you're going to do?
These numbers here, I have to put it in the order that the prices are.
That's right.
And you give me... 30
seconds.
Give me 50 seconds.
50 seconds? Well, how would it be if I gave you 30 seconds, and then if you're not happy, I gave you another 30 seconds?
That's good.
All right, that's what I'll do. On your mark, get set, go. Get those prices right, and you win the prize. $6,528 for that automobile. $40. $69, $67, $79, and $50. Oh, she's changed the car to $6,568. Okay. All right, step right back here, Graciela. Now, we'll see how many you have right. How many does she have right? You have only one right. Now, of course, it might be the car. But I am going to give you another 30 seconds, and you can change anything you wish. Or you can leave it alone. What do you want to do?
I want to switch.
You want to make a few changes? Okay, go ahead. I'll give you 30 seconds more, Graciela. Put the six back. Okay, Graciela, step back over here. Now, how many does Graciela have right? Well, you're doing a little better. Now, listen, Graciela, if you had the car in the first place, you still have it. because you left the six up there. Okay, what is one of the prizes that she has won, please? You won the clock down there. It was $70. Now, what's the other prize she won? The car! We have just discovered that our audience is full of Canadians here, and we are certainly pleased to have you in the audience, and we're so happy to learn how popular Price is Right is up there in Canada. I got a television column just the other day. It's one of the highest rated shows, and we genuinely appreciate your interest. And then during that last message, there was a lady who wants me to say hello to Sarasota, Florida, but I'm not going to do that. Now, John,
yes.
Are you going to call another name for us?
Indeed I am, Bob, and it's Jacqueline Shelton. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
What are we going to bid on now, please?
It's a hearth stove. Hearth stove by Sierra. Warm your home from your fireplace with this high-efficiency wood stove. You can cook on it, too. A hearth stove by Sierra.
That's what we're bidding on, and it is Jacqueline who bids first.
$450.
$450.
$750.
$750. And now here's Sheila, who gave us the first bid of the day, if you will turn time back about 45 minutes. And she's going to try again.
$500.
$500. Jamie?
$501.
The actual retail price is $635. Jamie did it. She took it away from little Sheila. And Sheila had been with us for Jamie. Come back here, Jamie. Now, Jamie, where do you live?
Thousand Oaks.
Right here in the Los Angeles area, so you didn't come far to win all this.
A dinette set, a wall unit, and a rattan love seat. First from George Vann, a three-tier inter-air and mirror combination wall system. Handcrafted of hardwoods, this collection will be a handsome addition to any setting. Fine furniture from George Vann. Second, from Chrome Craft's Village Oak Collection, this handsome pedestal-based table and four armchairs are of solid oak. The chairs have easy roll casters and are upholstered in a small flower print from Chrome Craft. Finally, imported from the Philippines, this love seat is made of rattan with cushions upholstered in a floral-designed cotton fabric. A charming addition to any room. Okay, Bob?
Jamie, we would love to give you all three of those gifts. And we will. We will if you tell us which one is the most expensive. Take a look at number one over here. Is that the most expensive? Or is it number two? Or number three?
Number two.
Number two is the most expensive, according to Jamie. We shall check number one first. How much is number one? $1,100. How much is number three? $700. If number two is more than $1,100, you win all three prizes. And Jamie, if I were to bet, I would bet that you are a winner. I have a hunch you've done it. Show us the price of number two. You did it! $1,500. You win all three of those gifts. And we're going to spin the big wheel again in the second showcase showdown after this one. We're talking about money, money, money. Now, in the first showcase showdown, we did give away $1,000 on the big wheel here. And here we are in the second showcase showdown, and each of you could win as much as $11,000. What would you do with it, Graciela?
I will give half of it to my brother. He just got married.
He just got married, and you'll give him half of it? Well, that's wonderful. Is that your brother out there? Yes. I spot him. They're going to get a shot of him now. I spot him the moment. I was out of the corner of my eye. Raise your hand there. There he is. Out of the corner of my eye, the moment she said that, arms started flying around. Big smile. I knew that was the brother. What are you going to do with $11,000, Jamie?
Put it down on a house.
Very good idea. How about you, Roger?
I'd spend it well.
Yes, I'll bet you would. Step over there, and the first step toward getting the $11,000 is to get $1 on the wheel. Spin it, and, of course, the contestant nearest to $1 without going over is in the showcase. Yep, let her go. There is the first spin of the second showcase showdown. We gave away $1,000 in the first showcase showdown. We've had 5 winners out of 6 games, so we've had a pretty good day here. 55 cents. What are you going to do about that, Roger?
Oh, I'd spin again.
Go ahead. I'd do the same thing. Now, where's that 45 cents? We want that 45 cents. Where's that 45? There it goes. 55 plus what's coming up here? 40 would be very good. Oh, you're going to go over, Roger. You've gone over. Thank you for being on The Price is Right.
Thank you.
All right, Jamie. Big spin. There we go, Jamie. After $1,000. Hey, you may have 90 cents here. No, a nickel. I bet you're going to spin again, aren't you? Everything on the wheel will help her except the $1. The $1 will put her over. She has a nickel, and what are we going to add to that nickel? Hey, this could be a good score. Yes, you have 90 cents. That is a good score. Jamie has 90 cents. But here's Graciela, who watches every day up in Salt Lake City. Let's pick up a little money here, Graciela. I think she's going to spin again. 85 cents. Spin it again, Graciela. Here we go. She has 85 cents, and she's trying to beat 90 cents. 85. Oh, Graciela, this didn't work out very well. But you did very well.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Hope you continue to enjoy the show. Jamie, you have won the second showcase showdown. And the folks from Thousand Oaks are going to be right proud of you. We'll be back with the showcase itself after we show you this. Jamie, you have ended up as the top winner in our showcase today, and Catherine, you are the runner-up. Each of you will have a showcase of beautiful prizes to bid on, and the one of you who bids closer to the actual retail price of your own showcase without going over will win it. But if you are the winner, and you are less than $100 away from the retail price of your own showcase, then we give you both showcases. Now, Jamie, since you're the top winner, you have a good look at showcase number one. If you wish, bid on it. If you prefer, pass that to Catherine, and you wait for showcase number two. Do you understand, Catherine? Do you understand, Jamie? Then let's show them that first showcase.
Your showcase begins with this beautiful bedroom group. Passport by Bassett. This elegant bedroom features a door dresser with wing frame mirror, 6-drawer, 2-door chest, chair back headboard and 2 nightstands, and an Envoy birch finish by Bassett. And for a decorator's look, this bedding ensemble. A Coney Art Total Concept Irish Bedroom Ensemble in Oyster Wine Plum and Cream. A queen-size quilted bedspread graphic and matching pillows are manufactured by Coney Art of Los Angeles. And for a comfortable night's sleep, this mattress set. The Dreammaker from Bassett gives just the right combination of firm support and soothing softness from Bassett. And for those restless nights, you can relax in your new Redwood Spa. From Riviera, the portable Tiger hot tub, attractive redwood siding and molded fiberglass tub. Indoors or out, no installation, plug-in, ready to work, the portable hot tub from Riviera Spa. And this showcase can be yours if the price is right.
Jamie, that's the first showcase. What are you going to do about it? Are you going to pass it or are you going to bid on it?
I'm going to pass it.
You're going to pass it to Catherine. Catherine, it's yours. What do you bid on?
$4,200.
$4,200 is her bid on showcase number one. All right, Jamie, look at your showcase.
Your showcase contains all of the prizes mentioned in our Price is Right celebrity auction.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to our auction gallery. And today's item up for bid is this well-seasoned suitcase from the estate of that late, great, world-renowned traveler, Rufus T. Roadmap. Now, what am I bid for this travel-worn suitcase? Yes, yes, the lady in the front row. What are you starting the bidding with? Oh, I see. You're starting the bidding with a new picnic basket. Imported from England, this handsome wicker basket is completely fitted with service for four. Flatware, English china, two food containers, everything you need for a picnic except the food. I have a picnic basket. Do I have any other bids, bids, bids? Aha, the lovely blonde in the back row. Would you please stand up, please? Oh, you're raising your bid with a new movie camera and projector. From Hanamax, a Super 8 all-zoom movie kit with XL820 zoom camera and 808D movie projector. You can take and project brilliant movies the easy way from Hanamax. I now have a movie camera. Are there any other bids on this one-of-a-kind suitcase here? Yes, yes, yes. The lady, the redhead, the dazzling redhead. Will you stand up and show us what you're bidding, please? Well, now it looks like you've increased the bidding with a trip to Mexico. Flying holiday for two, air coach from Los Angeles to colorful Mexico City via Western Airlines wide-body DC-10 spaceship. Featuring Fiesta flight service the Western way. While in Mexico, you'll stay 6 nights at the ultra-modern Maria Isabel Sheraton Hotel, situated in the exciting Zona Rosa. You'll enjoy luxurious accommodations, warm hospitality, and friendly service at the Maria Isabel Sheraton.
And as luck would have it, our Holly has outbid her competition and now owns the suitcase and its contents, which includes the title to the last residence of Rufus T. Roadmap. A new trailer. Comfort Industries lightweight model 16-foot travel trailer. Fully self-contained with sparkling galley, shower, plus very comfortable dining sleeping areas. The Comfort Light Travel Trailer. And this showcase, brought to you by our Price is Right celebrity auction, can be yours if the price is right.
All right, Jamie, your time has come. What do you bid on this showcase?
$13,000.
$13,000 even. That's what she bids on this showcase. Catherine bid $4,200 on her showcase, and we'll be back to find out which one of these young ladies has won after we find out about this. Audience, do you believe it is Catherine who's won?
Yeah.
Or do you believe it is Jamie who won? I think Jamie has won. I'm going to start with Catherine. Catherine bid $4,200 on her showcase. Catherine, the actual retail price is $5,555. A difference of $1,355. Jamie must be closer than $1,355 and not go over in order to win. Her bid is $13,000. Actual retail price of her showcase, $9,339. You're over. You win, Catherine. Catherine has won almost, over $9,000. That's almost 10, including $1,000 in cash. Yes, you have done very well. Jamie, thank you for being on our show. Now, I want to take you over there and show you the footy prizes. Bob Barker saying goodbye, everybody.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for The Price is Right, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
You're riding in the sun all day. Refreshment seems a mile away. Now you're heading for home and your long day is through.
There's something big waiting for you. For you. Coffee Fit, the biggest taste you've ever found. Coffee Fit, the one that never lets you down. Coffee Fit, the most refreshing taste around. Coffee Fit.
It's the smile.
It's the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And now, here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy. Hello, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you. We have a hot group. No, I can hear you back there. I love it when the group is hot. There's nothing better than that. We got a hot group back here, and you're going to meet them, too. Right now, from Happy Days, Mr. Anson Williams and Laurie Mahaffey. Winning money for the banana section today, appropriately enough, Mr. Steve Allen and Jane Meadows. Winning money for the red section today, Christopher Joy and Denise Williams. Yay! You know that's true, Steve, and I know, and I've certainly, Anson, you know from working in front of live audiences all those years on the show, that you can feel audiences are all different.
Yes.
Every single time, and yes. This one, before I even got out here, I could hear them yelling and screaming for you guys. I knew it was going to be
wild,
which means they can also turn vicious real quick.
Animal spirits.
Yes, it's all right there. They're waiting to see which way it's going to go, you know. Okay, here we go. This first question, we're going to start things rolling right away, then we'll visit as we go along. Mm-hmm. The first question is for the ladies, as you know, worth $150 to your respective rooting sections, and this is the way it goes. Ladies, if the two of you ever decide to take a second honeymoon, will you go to the same place you had your first honeymoon, or will you go someplace else? Logical question. Ladies, go away and think about it. Anson, what will Laurie say to this? Steve is chuckling already. Well,
personally, I'd like to go to Palmdale, but...
You would, eh?
No. No, she's a romantic. Laurie's very, very romantic, and she'd want to go to the same places where we went on our first honeymoon.
Where did you go on your first honeymoon?
Well, San Ysidro Ranch, and then... in Santa Barbara. It's gorgeous. It's neat. Yes. Yeah. We got married there, stayed there a few days, and we went to Carmel, you know, Big Sur, San Francisco.
Oh, what's wrong with that?
Nothing. But I like Palmdale.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not going to pursue that. What happened to you in Palmdale, Anson?
None of your business.
None of my business. Thank you. They're doing that to me a lot lately. Did you notice that?
But whatever it was, he had to go to San Ysidro to get rid of it.
And couldn't get an answer there. I had to go to Monterey and Carmel for a second and third opinion. All right. You'll say, Laurie will say, the same place.
Yes.
Here she comes.
Where are you going to go? What are you going to do for the second honeymoon, Laurie?
Well, if it's up to me, that wasn't really clear to me, but if it's my decision, Anson didn't plan too well for the last one. Mm-hmm. He didn't make any reservations. It was Thanksgiving week. We spent the last night of our honeymoon at a hotel over a gas station.
Uh-huh.
So it'd be a little different this time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, that's not what he said. Isn't that funny? You notice
Laurie.
How the stories come out totally different.
Laurie?
What?
He
Laurie?
Said.
What?
What about all the romantic places up the coast, you know? All the way up to San Francisco?
Romantic places? We took the last room they had anywhere we went.
Once over a gas station, once under a gas station.
One was again.
You walk 10 blocks, you hit the ocean, Laura. I mean,
it's only 2 blocks to the ocean.
It makes me mad just thinking about it again. I'm not speaking to you.
I'm sorry. There may not be a second honeymoon, you know?
Be romantic, you know.
Please, don't fight. You got it wrong. It's the way it is. I'm sorry.
Your fault, Laura.
Steve, what will Jane say to this one?
This poses an interesting dilemma for all you dilemma posers out there. Jane and I never really had an official honeymoon, you know, where you get silk pajamas and you go to Cleveland or something.
Yeah.
We were both so busy that we just went right back to work.
Right.
But if we had a honeymoon, yes. I think Jane would want to go back to the same place, so I give you that answer.
You wait a minute. If you had a honeymoon, which you didn't have, she'd like to go back to the same place.
Yeah.
Which is nowhere at this point.
I rest my case.
Step down.
You gave us an A or B choice. I mean, if we had a honeymoon, she would have had to go back to the same head place.
I'm not going to panic here. I'm going to be very calm.
No,
you see, what you could do, however, Jane is liable to say, we never had a honeymoon, so how can I make a choice? So I'll just have to say...
Well, she might say the same kind of a thing. If we ever did, I would have liked to go there. Or, no, I would like to go to a different place each time.
Yeah.
Or if she has a honeymoon with some other guy sometime. So. It could work any million
ways. Well, this could go... You could also say, we didn't go any place, so how can I make a choice? That would match her. She may say, we didn't have one. I mean, if you have to do that, see, I don't want to confuse the issue.
You have. Here.
I'm sorry. Let's say that she'll say, if you had one, you will go back to the same place.
I'll stand on my constitutional rights.
Okay. Here she comes. Jane, we need an answer from you. What are you going to do on your second honeymoon?
Well, I hope we're going to do something. We never had a honeymoon the first time.
Yeah?
And did Steve tell you about What's My Line?
No.
We were married on a Saturday, and on Sunday he was a panelist at What's My Line, and I was the mystery guest, and he didn't guess me.
Oh!
As a matter of fact, I was doing a high voice, and he said, I don't know who you are, but you sound like Minnie Mouse.
Oh!
So I hope you'll take me anywhere. I'll settle for anything.
Well, but we need an answer. He has given us a choice. So what we want to know from you, will you go the same place or someplace else?
Someplace else?
No.
Oh, you mean I have to say where we would go?
No.
Game is over.
But what happened? It was almost an impossible answer for you
since
you didn't go someplace.
We didn't go anywhere.
Well, he said if you did go someplace, had you gone to someplace...
I would have gone back there.
That's what he said.
Oh, sure. Sure, I would have gone back there. Don't worry. Yeah.
I submit, Your Honor, that the witness is being deliberately evasive.
Now, that's good game playing. Oh, yes, I would have done that. I'm sorry, nobody's gotten this right, so it's not
But I got it right.
No, but only on the fourth try. It doesn't really...
Oh, I see.
It doesn't really count. It was hard. It was impossible for you. Christopher, you can get the whole thing right off the bat here for the red section.
All right.
What do you think?
Well...
Tell us about your honeymoon,
I know
sir.
That Denise would want to go back to the same place. We were up in Carmel and Monterey on our honeymoon. And we had a great time.
Yeah.
We only had a few days because we were both working.
As a matter of fact, they had your room, Anson.
that's the one.
Oh, you went to Palm Deal too.
Yeah. In fact, nowhere is not a bad place to go. But no, I think she would say go back to the same place
back
because
to the same
we want
place.
To go back there.
Okay, here she comes. Denise, you can get the whole thing here. I almost said you can get the whole thing for the nephew, but I didn't do that. I wouldn't, because you know your name is spelled like niece, isn't it?
I know. My mother wanted to be unique. What can I tell you?
No, I think it's terrific. Now, the answer we're looking for you is either you will go to the same place or someplace else.
Well, our honeymoon was so special. It was a little hideaway that I had, in passing, said to Christopher I'd like to go, and he took me, and we had such a wonderful time. I'd say. I'd go back to the same place.
That's the one. You got it. You got it all for the red section, too.
And we'll come back in a moment with question number two. Don't miss it. Got a good group today. See you in a minute.
Look, quick. Hello. Hi, we're back. Question number two coming your way in just a moment. And if you're ready, ladies, it is for you. You got to play catch up to Denise. She's got all the money. Ladies, you're going to a dressy party. How many outfits will you try on before you decide on one? Will it be just one, two, or more than that? Good question. Off you go. And Steve, we're going to start with you.
This is the only time of the many times I've been in this program that I have ever been absolutely confident that I knew the answer, and if Jane doesn't agree with me, I'll kill her. Uh-huh. Because in her case, God love her, it's always three or more.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah. She doesn't make up her mind quickly. Does she ask you for your advice?
Yes, she does.
And what do you say?
I ask her for advice about my clothes, too.
Yeah. But, I mean, I suppose she put on the second dress or the third dress and you're late.
Believe it or not, I happen to have good taste in women's clothing.
Oh, so I believe that. I've seen you a number of... Oh, I'm sorry.
I taught Milton Berle everything he knows. No, but I go with this answer.
Okay, you'll say... what was our answer? More than that is what it was.
More than that,
Here she comes. Jane, we're looking for a choice here. What are you going to do?
Well... this is one of my big problems in life. I always have to ask Steve. I line up. We have these things in our doorways that the kids used to chin themselves on. And I hang dozens of dresses up there.
Yes.
And then I go down the line and I say to Steve, do you think I should wear this one? And he says, beautiful, anything. And I say, no, I don't think I'll wear that one. And I just keep going because... I don't know why. It's just one of my big problems in life.
So?
I don't always try on more than that. One, two. But I think I do try on more than two very often.
So your answer is more than that, and you're correct. That's what he said. Absolutely right. The reason I was trying to lead Steve a little bit, I said, when you're on your second or third dress and Jane says, how does this look? And sometimes you're not even looking. You're combing your hair. You say, great. Oh, it looks great, honey.
That's late. That's what he does.
I think all husbands have been guilty of that.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Yes.
Because women always will ask you, how does it look? And you don't know. It depends on what you want to wear, you know. They all look good.
Yeah, but when you ask us, we give you our undivided attention.
That's because we have white socks on with brown pants and black shoes, you know. You can't do that, dummy. Christopher, what will Denise say?
The question is, try on more?
Will she, before she decides which one to wear to this dressy party, will she try on just one, two, or more than that?
She looks at a lot. Try on, actually put on. Probably more than two.
So it'd be more than that.
Yeah, more than two.
More than that.
Yeah, she'll go through this outfit.
She has gowns that she works in, too. I mean, she must have all kinds of stuff.
But that's a different closet.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, what am I saying?
It's a different thing.
Mercy.
Well, I mean, it's, you know, like the glitter.
Yeah, right, the glitter closet.
You know, when she goes out, when we're going out together, the glitter stays at home.
I see. You wear the glitter. Okay.
Right.
Here she goes. Denise.
Yeah.
We need a choice from you on... how many are do you try on more than one? How many do you try on?
This is a hard one. I didn't have this problem when I had a teeny weeny wardrobe, you see.
Yes.
But since it's...
Since you're a hit.
Since I'm a hit.
Things have changed.
I would say that I've been known to try at least two.
You'd say that?
I would say at least
two. Christopher said more than that.
What?
Welcome to Tattletales.
Not more than that.
Would you like to explain yourself?
Not more than that?
No, one or two, but...
I remember when you looked at two or three things, you tried on a couple, and then went out and bought something totally different.
That's true.
That's true. See, they straightened it out.
And that's
you're still wrong.
The way it is.
Yes, of course. Answer, what will Laurie say?
Could you repeat the question, please?
Yes, the question is, you're going to a dressy party. How many outfits will you try on before you decide on one?
Oh, I just try one, on about two. Six. Oh.
Not you.
Not me.
One,
she,
two, or more than
she...
that.
Gosh, I hope she's honest. At least three.
At least three?
Yes.
So your answer is more than that?
Yes, more than two.
Really?
Yes.
So you can't make up her mind either, huh?
No.
Puts the pressure on you, does she?
Yes.
Sometimes?
A lot.
The answer is more than that. Here she comes. Lori, we need a choice.
Well, it depends on whether I'm fat or not. If I'm fat that week, I have my, you know, I have to go through a couple.
Yeah.
And that's the majority of the time. So I would say two.
No, he said more than that. Which means Jane and Steve get the whole thing for the banana section. There you go. Step to the rear, gentlemen. It's halftime. We will bring the ladies out front, and we'll come back with the second half of Shadow Bills after this message for you. Don't go away. We're back after halftime, and I have the ladies with me. The fellas are in the back, and gentlemen, you should know that we have two-thirds of a tie. Steve and Christopher are tied with $150 apiece, and Anson, you're going to get on the boards right now, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. This question is addressed to the fellas. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. Men, your wonderful, efficient, live-in housekeeper ask you if her boyfriend can sleep over in her bedroom whenever he wants to. Who is more likely to say yes? You, fellas, your wife, both of you, or neither of you?
Huh.
Okay? Oh. Wants to know if the boyfriend can sleep in her room whenever he wants to. Off you go. Good question. We'll start with Denise. What do you think Christopher will say to that?
Boy, oh boy, out the door, probably.
Really? Oh, he wouldn't go for that.
I don't think I'd go for it.
Marissa. Really?
No, I'd probably say, I think you better do it somewhere else. And I think he'd probably say,
No. Yeah, it would worry you. You think maybe it's, how long have you been married?
I think so. Not a year yet.
Well, that's probably why. I mean... After all,
newlyweds. No, we'll be married a year, July 3rd.
All right, so he will say.
Thank you.
He will say both of you, or will he say himself? What will he say? Do you think? Would rather? Who is more likely to say yes? Neither of you, maybe.
Neither.
Okay. Is that what you mean? I see. I gotta watch. I get this question.
Oh, really?
Around.
Is it one of those kinds?
No, really. But it says who is more likely to say yes. You just said you'd both disapprove, which means you both say. No.
Yeah, we would both say no.
Who's more likely to say yes? Neither of you is the answer. I got it. Here he comes. You think it's easy, don't you? Figuring this out. Christopher.
Yeah.
What is your answer, sir?
Well, first of all, somebody has to point out to me who this efficient young live-in housekeeper is. I've never seen her in my place. But neither of us.
That's correct. Very well done, sir.
No, I'm proud of you, honey.
Thank you, Christopher. Lori, what will Anson say?
There's no telling today.
That's true.
He's really off today. I think if he's really... He's not being honest. See, that's the problem. Oh. I apologize that we don't have
you
any
mean
points.
You mean Anson Williams is lying on network television?
It's not that he's lying. I think he's trying to second guess. He's forgetting that, you know, the other questions... This is his perspective, right? These questions. See, I understand how to do the game.
I see.
He doesn't.
I got it.
Okay, got that straight.
There'll be hell to pay at home tonight, won't there, gang?
I'd say neither of us.
Neither of you would approve. Mm-hmm. Here he comes. Anson, we are looking for approval or not.
Well, I think the key here is whenever he wants to.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say neither of us.
That's correct.
Oh, goodness.
I thought we'd get a little more trouble with this one, but we didn't. Jane, what do you think Steve will say?
Well, I agree with Denise. We both go to the same church, and we're very old-fashioned people, Steve and I. We wouldn't put up with any of that jazz. They would have to get married or, you know, go somewhere else.
Or ship out.
Yeah.
All right, the answer is neither of you.
Neither of us.
Here he comes. Yeah. Steve, we're looking for your approval or disapproval. What will happen here?
Well, I take a very dim view of that sort of thing. And I would say that Jane does too, and neither of us would.
That's correct. You got it. You all got it. We'll split that three ways. It wasn't very hard for you. But we'll get you with the next one, and we're going to do that right after this message for you with a $300 question. See you tomorrow. It was nice. Okay, here we go. We're visiting a little bit quickly, but this one's got to go fast. $300, and this will decide the game. Close game, and even Anson can win. Men, it's for you. How much would you say... Now, listen to this. It's a good question. How much would you say the women's liberation movement has affected your life? A lot, a little, or not at all? How much would you say? Goodbye, guys. Good question. And we can talk about it for a long time. We're going to move it a little bit. What do you think Anson will say, Laurie?
A lot.
A lot?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, it's affected me, so therefore it affects him.
Really?
It better.
Has he adjusted to it? Does he like it?
I think he does. He didn't in the beginning, but he's a lot more supportive now.
Coming around. Yeah. So you'll say a lot. Mm-hmm. Here he comes. Anson, how much has it, in fact?
The Women's Liberation Movement. Well, it's a lot of people running through the house, but I think Lori has always been liberated, so I would say not at all.
That's not what Lori said, but you were very close.
Boy, am I going to liberate him. Oh.
No, I just thought you were your own individual, Lori.
Lori said a lot, a whole lot. Sorry
it's
about
really
that.
It's really a lot, Bert.
I'm sorry. Jane, what will Steve say?
Well, I think that Steve has always been very sympathetic to the women's movement. I think he will say a little. He would not say not at all. And I don't think you would have to say a lot. But I'm the one it's changed a lot.
Yes.
I'm a militant feminist.
Are you?
Militant.
Mercy.
Yes. So beware.
But even with all that, he'll still say a little.
I think he'll say a little because, you know, I don't think he had to change a lot.
Yeah.
It would be nice if he said a lot. But it's what he will say. Oh, I mustn't talk too much. A little.
You have all the time in the world. He will say a little. Because it's a lot for you. Even with it being a lot for you, it's still only a little for him.
I think so.
See how quickly I picked that up?
Have to think what he's going to say,
right? Here he comes. All right, yes. Steve, we're getting down to it now. This will probably decide the game. What do you think?
Well, I support women's campaign for freedom and equality, and we've had Susan B. Anthony as a guest on our Meeting of Minds show. I would say it has affected my thinking and my life a lot.
No, that's not what Jane said, but it was close. She said a little. She said it affected hers a lot and yours a little. And she
because
was...
Because you already were kind to women, darling.
Yes, darling.
That's
you forgot that.
That's why we did Susan B. Anthony and everything, but anyway, I'm proud you said a lot.
Yes, I'm too.
I'm so proud. Proud.
The yellow section doesn't really care a heck of a lot. Denise, what will Christopher say? This will decide the game.
Well, because he's really, I think my husband is old-fashioned and believes in the submissive woman and the this and the that. But he knew in marrying me that there's going to have to be some changes made.
Yeah.
And so I would say for him that it has meant a lot.
A lot.
I would say a lot.
Here he comes. Christopher, this will decide the game. How much has it meant to you? Affected your life?
I would say it's only affected it a little.
No, that's not what Denise said. No one got that one right. So the game is up. Time is up. We have a tie. Jane and Steve and Denise and Christopher win it. Everybody missed that.
What did she say? No, not at all.
Like that. They didn't even come close, did they? We'll come back in a moment and split up the money. Wait a minute. Okay, we had a tie. Jane and Steve and Denise and Christopher with $200 apiece. We had $1,000. They will divide $700 between those two sections. Very nicely done. Thank you all for being with us on Tattletales. Bert County saying so long. I'll see you next time. Thank you.
In addition to cash awards, a member of the winning rooting section selected at random will also receive Harlequin Books, More Than Romance, and Super Romance in the paperback world of worldwide romance. Ronco Clean Air, the anti-pollution machine that removes offensive odors and harmful pollutants from the indoor air you breathe from Ronco. A serving tray and Archway home-style cookies, over 30 delicious varieties baked from homemade recipes. Archway, the big cookie with a small-town taste. And Volrath stainless steel kitchenware is the choice of many finer restaurants to prepare, cook, and serve food in your home. The value is Volrath. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.
Well, that's our show for today and our game show Time Warp. We'll be back next time. Until then, good night.